you. Tate Smith is a thing of the past here, folks. They haven't been using her, I guess, Mike, all year long. I guess they feel that the magic has worn off, and Cade, who had such an incredible record with God Bless America, has disappeared into the sunset and probably gone chasing that moon over the mountain or whatever.
That's
she used
exactly
to do,
right? Right. That's exactly right. By the way, why don't you tell the folks about Rick McLeish? He's
right.
He has got a problem. I'll tell you what I'll tell him about.
Go right ahead.
Rick McLeish is playing his first game in about a week and a half. About 10 days ago, the Flyers were out in California, and they played the Kings. And Marcel Dion, courtesy of Marcel, he skated across Rick's neck, totally unintentional. He took 80 stitches in his neck. The doctor said he just missed the jugular. And that, I'll tell you, would have been very, very dangerous. In any case, Rick is playing with those 80 stitches in his neck, and it's got to be hurting. Can you imagine getting 80 stitches in your neck?
That doesn't sound very good,
wow.
I'll tell you that. Well, let's give you the starting lineups. It's Doug Favell in goal for the Colorado Rockies against his old goaltending partner, Bernie Perrant. At center ice, Dennis Duperrey, number 15, the key to the late-season surge of the Rockies to put him in the playoffs with 9 goals in his last 15 games. Mike Kitchen on the left wing, got a bit of a sore thumb, but he's playing tonight. Will Paymon, number 9, on the right. On defense, it's Barry Beck and John Van Boxmeer. For the Flyers, Orris Kinderchuk gets it back to Bob Daly and over to Rick LaPointe. Daly brings it to center, shoots it into the Colorado zone. Comes off to the goal line, shot to the near boards, and racing for it there is Bridgman. Loses it to Van Boxmeer, and it goes to center. Across the blue line, and the Flyers are offside. So a quick offside against Philadelphia. The Rockies on the season have won 2 games against this team. They beat him in Denver by scores of 6-4 and 4-3. Also lost in Denver by a score of 6-3. They were shut out here 3-0 and also lost 6-2 in their last appearance here. And of course, the Rockies decimated by injuries throughout most of the year. 18 different players have been out with injuries this season, but right now as healthy as they've been since early January. Orris Kinderchuk was studying to be an ophthalmologist. Off the faceoff, it goes upstairs into the seats. We'll have another faceoff in the neutral zone. And oh, look out. Looks like somebody got hurt right off the bat here as that puck went flying into the seats right behind the Rocky bench.
Orris Kinderchuk almost needed one the last time the Rockies were in here. Barry Beck, always the gentleman on the ice, could have wrapped him and thrown him into the third deck, but Barry showed a lot of courtesy.
That was Doug Favell, of course, in your picture, showing his season record. Now the puck back to Barry Beck. Over to John Van Boxmeer. Johnny coming off a superb season for Colorado. Left wing side to Beck. Shoots it into the Philadelphia zone. Goes in, upstairs, into the seats again. So we'll have another quick faceoff here. This is, of course, one of 4 playoff games going on tonight. We've got the New York Rangers against the Buffalo Sabres. You've got to look for Buffalo to be a favorite there. Toronto and Los Angeles opening up in Toronto. And what I think will be the toughest series, Detroit down in Atlanta in the first of a 3-game series. Dennis Duperrey against Orris Kinderchuk. In the neutral zone, Neil Armstrong has worked more games than any linesman in the league. Tisbury drops the puck. F center ice. Taken by Colorado along the boards. Kitchen can't get it. Comes back to John Van Boxmeer. Johnny brings it up the right wing. Shoots it down into the Philadelphia zone. In behind Bernie Perrant over to Bob Daly. Daly with 21 goals on the year. At the far boards, Duperrey tying it up. Gets it out to Beck at the point. He drills it. It's deflected to the near boards. Flyers' Mel Bridgman, a number 1 pick at 75. Clears out the left wing. Picked up by Daly. Daly shoots it into the middle and over to Rick LaPointe, a number 1 pick of the Detroit Red Wings in 75. In behind Favell. Bridgman racing for the puck, but it comes to the near boards of Van Boxmeer. John out the right wing, gives it to Dennis Duperrey. Across center ice, moving left to right into the Philadelphia zone, and the Flyers win the race for the puck. Rick LaPointe at his own goal line of the Rockies in a line change. That's Freddie Ahern, number 24. Over to Hudson. Hudson's got Spruce out in front, goes with a soft backhander, and it goes wide. Daly takes it behind the net. Spruce with a 40-point season, 19 goals, 21 assists. Oucher with a steal, keeps it in the zone behind the net to Andy Spruce. Spruce trying to put it out in front, but it goes to the far boards to Captain Bobby Clark, 3-time MVP in the National Hockey League. Brings it across his own blue line to center. Moving on leftly, and Oucher trying to beat him, goes around him, and they take the puck away. Freddie Ahern out to Spruce on the left wing. Boy, is Andy thrilled to be here, too. Andy Spruce, I'll tell you that. He played at Vancouver last year and was dropped. Came to the Rockies as a free agent, as we said, a superb season with 19 goals and 21 assists. Has the puck out to Dave Hudson. Hudson up the right wing to Freddie Ahern. From the blue line, he drills it wide. To Spruce at the left wing. Out to Lefley, who was superb in the game Saturday night against St. Louis. Now Billy Barber brings it to center. Up the right wing. A 41-goal score into Bladen, and it's taken by Oucher. Dennis Oucher, who's had playoff experience with the Pittsburgh Penguins. A right wing pass for Hudson. Off his stick in behind the net. Bernie Perrant to the near boards to Billy Barber, a number 1 pick in 1972. Now Randy Pierce, Contini on the ice. Larry Skinner coming out in a moment, and this line has been superb since it was put together 3 games ago. Up the right wing side to McLeish, a quick wrist shot, and Favell, a fine save on his knees. to Larry Skinner, past Contini, and all the way down to the Philadelphia end. Kevin McCarthy, number one pick of the Flyers this year, from DuPont, back to Kevin. Into the Colorado zone, in behind the net. Favelle slows it down, gives it to Van Boxmeer, and it rolls away anyhow to the near boards. Pierce has to go backcourt. In behind the net, Barry Beck, no score in the first period. We've played so far just 3 minutes. Now Skinner on the left wing, right side to Pierce. Pierce to the Philadelphia line, going through with a great move. He has hauled off the puck, forced into the boards, and the Flyers grab the loose puck. Don't expect Dave Newell to call a close game. It's not his style. Puck to the near boards in the Colorado zone. Reggie Leach to Lonsberry, who had a hat trick in the last game against the Rockies here. Behind the hit, net to McLeish, and he fires it too far down the ice, all the way to the Philadelphia goal line. Perrant way out of the net. Back to DuPont. Ooh, Skinner almost stole it. Now it comes back to Kitchen, trying to stay onside, waiting for Skinner to get onside. Near boards, Andre DuPont, the Moose, as they call him. Back to Oucher, flips it in, wide to Perrant. And it's at the goal line. Over to Kevin McCarthy. He lost it to Paymon, looking for a man out in front. Holds it, feeds it out in front. Bounces to Oucher. Dennis can't hold it, but he gets a check-in on Bridgman. Oh, jumps across the blue line to center. Now Bridgman up the left wing. He's got Kindrachuk in the middle, leftly back on defense. Hard check into the boards by Oucher. Fans thought there should have been a penalty, apparently. They're booing. Now the puck over the net, and oh my, as you can see, it bounced just over the top of the net. Oucher behind his own net, being pressed by Kindrachuk. Gets away from him and brings it up the middle. No score, 4 minutes gone, first period. Right wing to Duperrey. Played here briefly for the Philadelphia Firebirds in February. And stayed as long as, much longer than he had planned. I guarantee he didn't want to be here at all. I don't blame him. Now the puck out to center ice to Kindrachuk. In the neutral zone, leftly on defense. Played the game of his, maybe his career Saturday night against the St. Louis Blues. Now the Flyers grabbing for the puck behind the Colorado net. But Van Boxmeer trying to clear it. Taken by the point. Open man, Zaleski. He shuts it over the net. Good chance for the Flyers, but no goal. Zaleski, 27 goals on the year. His career high this year, but no goal. Back into the Philadelphia zone, in behind Perrant, to the near boards to Rick Lapointe, continuous action. Right wing side to the big bird, Zaleski. Andruff is out on the ice now for Colorado. That's the Chief, DeLorme, 27. Lost it, here's Daly, takes a shot, blocked away by Beck. Rolls to the side of the net. Now to the near side to Ron DeLorme. A big goal in that closing game Saturday night to put the Rockies in the playoffs. Oh, a hard check by Daly. Daly is 6'5", by the way. Now to Bobby Clark, the captain of the Flyers, at his own blue line, winding up, coming down the middle, right wing, and a pass too far for Holmgren. Checked off by Beck, but he keeps the puck. Goes into the board. Beck falls down. Holmgren loses it to Clark, takes it behind the net. Puts it out to the point. Here's Bladen as a fight is starting. A shot goes wide, and it looks like we got something brewing.
We certainly do, Joe.
DeLorme and Holmgren.
And Holmgren.
Boy, they want to get at each other, and it would be quite a battle if they do. Holmgren, the acknowledged policeman on this team, since Schultz has left, I guess, Mike.
Well, they've tried to get Dave Hoyta to fill in that role, but Dave Hoyta just didn't have the ability on the ice to stick with the team. As in fact, he's sitting on the bench right now. He's not sitting on the bench. He's sitting up here in the press box. He had the fists, but he didn't have the stick.
And there's Beck and Watson grabbing hold of one another. Jimmy Watson and Barry Beck, and Dave Newell slithering into the middle of the pack right now, and we'll see if he calls some penalties here. And so while he does that, we've got 5.5 minutes gone in the first period. We'll pause in a scoreless tie.
Well, House, what do you think of the paint job?
You missed a spot.
Where?
Over to the left a bit.
Yeah.
That's it. Ah.
You know, House, you cost me a lot of money.
Fred, I'm the best investment you've got. Ask First of Denver. They'll lend you the money to make you even better.
Mm.
A home improvement loan makes good sense. As my value increases, so does yours.
You know, House? You're beautiful.
I was, till you painted me this tacky color.
Penalty calls coming up here at the Spectrum. No score in the first periods.
Each of 10-minute misconduct.
And 10-minute misconduct's involved here too, Mike.
That's funny because Newell really is
Colorado
causing this.
Number 27, Ron DeLorme.
Pick him up here.
And Flyers penalty to number 17, Paul Holmgren. Each a 10-minute misconduct.
Well, that's a rather strange call with no other penalties involved.
Well, obviously, they didn't take any shots at each other. All you can think is maybe they pushed the linesman or said something that was not very kind to Dave Newell. But Newell is asking for it. He has called such a loose game. We've picked up maybe 30 penalties already that have not been called. He's letting them go both ways. And there's a replay of what happened. You'll see not very many punches were thrown.
I don't don't know how you can give a man a 10-minute misconduct with nothing else called when it's a battle between the two players, unless they said something uncivilized to the referee, which they might have after the fact. But why that doesn't make sense.
Doesn't make sense at all, but so far, the way Dave Newell's called the game, it doesn't make sense anyway. He has let them go at each other, and he has not called some very, very obvious penalties.
Okay, so that means the teams remain at full strength, and Mike Christie out on the ice for the Rockies for the first time in 9 games. And an offside quickly at the Philadelphia blue line. No score in the first period. We've just played 5.5 minutes so far. And Dave Newell worked the game on Saturday night against St. Louis. And we mentioned at the time that we were a little disturbed that they had picked Newell because we felt that with the only playoff berth still at stake, they should go with the best in the league. And Newell proved very quickly that he wasn't. Dave Hudson on the faceoff against Bobby Clark just outside the Philadelphia blue line. Puck goes down into the Philadelphia zone. They try to clear it out. Hudson holds it in. They're trying to get it to Ahearn, but now we're getting a penalty call on Jimmy Watson for getting the stick underneath Dave Hudson, apparently.
And that was a well-deserved call. Jimmy is squawking about it, but he put his stick right between his legs because he was afraid Hudson was going to sneak by him. It was a penalty he had to take, but he shouldn't be screaming about it afterwards.
Jimmy Watson, 2 minutes for tripping.
Jimmy Watson at 5:42, just 12 seconds after the penalties to DeLorme and Holmgren.
Do you think maybe Newell hurt us?
Well, it's possible that he realizes that it is getting a little bit out of hand very early, and they've got to be careful of that. Now, the Rockies on the power play, 63 goals on the year in 280 opportunities, and that 63 goal total, by the way, is fourth in the National Hockey League's final standing. The percentage, though, overall was seventh. So Dennis Duperrey, Wilf Paimon, and Ralph Klassen. You're looking at Billy Barber talking to Fred Shiro right now about what happened, I guess, on that last call and maybe some strategy here on the penalty killing unit. Bobby Clark will take the faceoff for the Philadelphia Flyers as Billy Barber skates back into the action. Faceoff to the right-hand side of Bernie Perrant. Beck at the left point. John Van Boxmeer at the right side. Rockies power play, one of the best in the league, even with the loss of Paul Gardner, who, when he went out after 46 games, led the National Hockey League in power play goals. Klassen gets it out to the point to Beck. Back into Ralph, tried to give it back to Beck, stolen away by the Flyers, and it jumps across the blue line to Barry Beck. Big Bubba, what a season he had. Been an all-time scoring record for defensemen in the NHL. Drills it from the blue line, and it was low, and it just missed. Along the near boards, tied up there. Paimon gives in on the play, trying to kick it loose, but it's held there for a faceoff. Barry Beck on the season, 22 goals, 38 assists for 60 points. The 22 goals led the National Hockey League among all defensemen in scoring, and in addition to that, his 60 points has set a new record with Reed Larson. Larson and he have tied now, 60 points on the year, a rookie record for scoring by a defenseman of the National Hockey League. And it's kind of nice that they tied because it was quite a battle all year between them.
The one thing you've got to watch out for when you've got a power play on the Flyers is Clark and Billy Barber. They've worked together so long, they can really burn you with a shorthanded goal.
Now the puck to center ice to Barry Beck. Number one pick of the Rockies from New Westminster last season. Comes back into the Colorado zone. Randy Pierce just jumping out on the ice. Pierce been dogged by injuries all season long. Has only played 35 games. Back to the Moose. DuPont fires it down to the Colorado end of the ice with 1:15 remaining on the power play and no score in the first period. Now Van Boxmeer in his own zone. Gives it to Big Bubba. Barry across his own blue line. Across to Van Boxmeer on the right wing to the Philadelphia line. Shoots it in. Selesky shoots it out. Selesky, known primarily as a defensive forward and penalty killer in his early years, but now his third straight year of over 20 goals. 1 minute to go on the power play. Beck staying away from Selesky at the near boards. Shoots it across ice, gets it to Skinner. Skinner, right wing pass, broken up off the skate of Selesky and taken by Kindrachuk. Kindrachuk still in possession, doing a good job of ragging the puck, brings it into his own zone. Contini can't get it away. Up the right side to Kindrachuk, moves on Beck, goes down the middle. Still ragging the puck beautifully. Drops it back to Tommy Bladen at center ice. Excellent job by the Flyers. And now they're offside. No, I thought there was a whistle. No, now there's a whistle for a high stick. And so 27 seconds remaining on the power play. This, Mike, of course, has the possibility of being a very physical game. The Flyers very upset about the fact that the Rockies have beaten them the last two times they've met, and I'm sure want to prove something early to these guys.
Well, I think the Flyers are more upset at the fact that they weren't in first place and they're going to have to play this game to begin with. They're really upset about that, and of course, how physical it is really depends on Dave Newell and what kind of control he has over this game, and we're just going to have to watch and see what happens.
Dave Hudson out now for the Colorado Rockies. He missed a good portion of the year with a bad back problem, shoulder problem. So just about everybody was injured at one time or another. Only Van Boxmeer and Paimon played every game this year. Now Oucher shoots it to center. Hudson into the Philadelphia zone. Comes out in front of Perron. Clears it to the boards. Here's Hudson at the left circle. Back out to the point to Lepley. Lepley back into Hudson at the left circle. Has room. Takes a quick shot off the arm of Perron. And we're down to 10 seconds. Back out to Lepley. To Lifter at the blue line. Taking the windup. Holding the puck. They're running out of time. Here's Oucher. He's got a lane. He moves it. He shoots. Perron with a save. Puts it up in the air over the net. Rick LaPointe grabs it. Hudson ties him up behind the net. The penalty over. Team's back at full and equal strength. No score in the first period. 12-13 remaining. We'll be right back. Back at the Spectrum in Philadelphia, the first period of the first playoff game. The Rockies and the Flyers, Joe Starkey and Mike Forrest. Brian Lepley along the near boards in the Colorado zone, being pressed off the puck. Trying to get it behind the net. A feed out in front, just broken up at the side of the net. Out of the near boards to Freddie Ahern. Comes out to DuPont. His shot deflected. Leach can't get it. Reggie, very disappointing year for him. Freddie Ahern grabbing the puck in the neutral zone, loses it back to Leach. Shoots it back into the Colorado end. Leach a 45-goal score, then a 61-goal score for Philadelphia, but has sat on the bench a lot this year and scored under 30 goals on the year. Now right wing to Ahern, into the Philadelphia zone. Comes back to Spruce. He drills it wide, and it hits the back of the net. Leach grabs it there. Started as the number one pick of the Bruins in 70. Then to the Steels in 72. And over here in 1974 for the immortal George Basut. And the puck goes upstairs into the seats at the Spectrum. Al McAdam and Larry Wright all involved in that trade as well. And the only one that's really had a respectable showing off of considering the magnitude of the trade really is McAdam, who was a two-year All-Star for California and Cleveland.
This game so far, Joe, really has not caught fire. If anything, the Rockies have had the better of the play. A lot of the action's been down around Bernie Parent, and I think the Rockies have got to be congratulated so far during the game.
9 minutes gone in the first period and no score. The puck back to Barry Beck. Over to the near side to John Van Boxmeer. Back across to Beck in his own zone. Trying to bring it up. Trying to avoid Kindrichuk up the right wing. Broken up by Jimmy Watson. His older brother Joe has been with his team since it started in 67. Across to Barry Beck on the left wing side. Brings it out to center across the red line. Flips it in. Here's Paymont racing for the puck. Grabs it at the left circle. Looking for a man to pass it to. Runs into Selesky. Comes off to Kitchen. Kitchen back out to the point to Beck. Winds up. Drills it. And there's a rebound. And Bernie, as it rolled out in front of him, comes back to Selesky. Kindrichuk on the left wing, moving on Van Boxmeer. Has a man open, Bridgman in deep, oh, Favelle, an excellent save as he cut the angle and knocked it down. Now Van Boxmeer grabbing the puck. They may put him in the box, and they will. The puck started to come off the net, and Johnny tried to tuck it back in. And they're going to call him for delay of game.
There he is, Joe, and he did it absolutely. Grabbed it with his hand. That's an absolute no-no. Usually the refs don't pick it up because they're out of position, but this one was just too flagrant. Newell was looking right at him, and he was picking it up out of the nets. We're going to see it again.
Let's watch this again here. There's Favelle making the save, and the puck bounces off. Goes back out behind the net, and here's John. You'll see him very clearly. This is a big mistake. You're not going to get away with that very often.
He put it back in the nets.
And as you can see, he did. Flyers on the power play, 23% on the year, 51 power play goals. Finished fourth in the National Hockey League overall percentage-wise. To the faceoff in the Colorado zone, Bobby Clark out against Dave Hudson. And off the draw. Ooh, almost came out to Leach, but Spruce gets it and shoots it down the ice, and the Flyers will regroup. Bob Daly working a point along with Billy Barber. Barber's been a 50-goal scorer in this league. In fact, his line with Leach and Clark a couple of years ago, 141 goals between them in one season, an all-time NHL record. The puck in behind the Colorado net to Barry Beck. Around the boards, out to the point. Daly holds it in, deflected. Oh, just over the net. Out of the near side to Hudson. Hudson chips at it. It doesn't leave. Held in by Barber. Back in behind the net. Oucher battling Clark as they grab each other by the stick. Now to Leach. Out to Daly. Daly across to Barber, back in front of the net. Coming out is Hudson. Now that's Bruce working on Daly. Pass across to McLeish. McLeish at the goal line. Beck trying to pick him up. Comes back to the left circle. Out in front, they got Daly. Pass in close, and oh, just over the stick of Daly. He couldn't quite reach it. Gets it back in the right circle. That big size really helped. Feed out to Barber. He shoots. Favelle with a save. It's chopped at. A high stick knockdown, and they didn't call it. Comes back loose. Goes back to McLeish. A sliding tackle practically by Hudson. Back to McLeish getting in. He shoots. Favelle with a save, and he covers up. My, oh, my. The Flyers are swarming on the net right now.
Joe, you talk to people here in Philadelphia, and what do they tell you? They say this series is going to depend on that man right there, number one, Doug Favell. If he's hot, the Rockies are going to be in it. If he's cold, the Flyers will swamp him, and he's hot tonight.
So a faceoff coming up in the Colorado zone. And it'll be the left-hand side of Doug Favell. Look at the work by Dougie on that one, getting down on his knees and just closing up and hanging on. No score in the first period. The second game Thursday night at McNichols Arena. If you do not have your tickets or were not a season ticket holder, get in line tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock at McNichols Arena. And don't forget, 534-PUCK, 534-PUCK all during the evening to order season tickets for next year. There's Horace Kinderchuk. 54 seconds remaining on the power play for the Philadelphia Flyers. Dennis Duperrey out as a penalty killer. Dennis has been in the playoffs with the Toronto Maple Leafs, but that's been about it. Now the Flyers, Kinderchuk at the right circle. Holds it there. Has Bladen out at the right point. Bladen fires it back into the right circle. Beck trying to pick it up, can't get it. Now they double team him almost. They have to back up now, go back into that box defense, try to protect the net, not go out too far. Back out to Bladen, a shot deflected. Oh my, I thought that was gonna make it. Seemed to hit the post and Favell. Now back to center ice to Lonsberry. Lonsberry back at the Philadelphia blue line. Duperrey slashes it away, back further with 24 seconds on the power play. Now to Kinderchuk. Kinderchuk lost it, a Paymon out as a penalty killer. Oucher steals it, can't keep it. Goes into the near boards and it shot up off the glass. Oucher at the goal line, falls down, trying to clear it. Blocked by Bladen, important play, gets it to the right circle. Time running out, 5 seconds. Beck does not get all of it, it only comes to the point. Here's Bladen, it rolls right in front of Favell, and he'll get the puck. And what are they calling here on Oucher?
They're going to call interference, I think, Joe. Right down in front of the net, Oucher took one of the Flyers down and out before the puck ever got there.
Okay, 8:15 remaining in the period. We'll pause in a scoreless tie.
It should start every morning, be comfortable, be economical. That's a smart buy.
You asked for it. The 78 Toyota Corolla two-door sedan. The smart money's on this Toyota. Sensational gas mileage that you wouldn't expect in anything so comfortable and smartly engineered, with a fully transistorized ignition for dependability. If you can find a better built small car than Toyota, buy it.
Here's a car as smart as me.
You asked for it, you got it, Toyota.
Well, the Rockies, Mike, just survived the first power play, and it's exactly, it ends at now Oucher in for interference at 11:45, so they got to start all over.
Well, I think they actually called it tripping. It could have gone any one of five different ways, but Gary Dornhofer was in the crease, which is his home, and Oucher just decked him.
So the Rockies going to have to hold him off again. Rockies have given up 53 goals against so far on the year when they've been shorthanded. Back to center ice, it comes to Billy Barber, over to the right wing side to Reggie. The Chief gets it in to Clark, left wing side, open man, McLeish scores! Oh, what a wrist shot by Rick McLeish from the left circle. Favell appeared to have enough of the net covered, but did you notice it just got inside the post? Great shot.
Yeah, those 80 stitches in Rick McLeish's neck didn't seem to bother him on that goal.
So his first playoff goal of the 1977-78 season.
Rick McLeish.
Watch it again. Look at him flip it. Quick, hard, quick wrist shot that Favell started to move on, and Bango was already by him.
Along with number 27, Reggie Leach.
Clark and Leach with the assist.
11:57.
So it's 1-0 Philadelphia on the power play goal. It took him 12 seconds.
First goal of the playoffs for the Flyers.
So a face-off at center ice, and there's the Flyers celebrating. Clark and Reggie Leach, McLeish. In fact, McLeish and Leach were both drafted in the first round at 70 by the Boston Bruins, right behind each other. Now both over in Philadelphia. Ron Andruff will be out at center for the Colorado Rockies. And a slight delay on the ice right now. Time of the goal, 11:57. And of course, in the playoffs, you start your points all over from scratch. The regular season is thrown out. Andruff at center. Ronnie's had some great goals for the Rockies this year, and he went from 4 to 15 goals for Colorado from last year to this. Now the Rockies in their own zone. Bob Kelly out, trying to catch up with Oucher. To the left wing it goes. Klassen trying to clear it, can't get it. Klassen, a number one pick of the Seals before he came over here from Cleveland to the Colorado Rockies. Now to Freddie Ahern at the near boards, came over in the same trade. To center to Klassen. Klassen breaking into the Philadelphia zone. He skated off it. Back to the Hound Dog, Bob Kelly up the right wing side, scored the winning goal in the Stanley Cup Finals against the Buffalo Sabres 3 years ago. Puck in the neutral zone, back to Ahern. Freddie from South Boston fires it into the Philadelphia end. Got his parents here at the game tonight, in fact. Off to Bladen. Bladen the left wing side to Lonsberry. Lonsberry, Roscoe as they call him, up the right wing side. Gets it to Kelly. Kelly avoids Christie. Mike hasn't played much tonight. Remember, he's not healthy. Mike at the far boards. Over to Klassen. Klassen looking for Andruff up in front of him. It gets away from him, about to center ice. Rocky's going with four lines during the game. In behind Favell. And Favell leaves it there for John Van Boxmeer. Now John out to Andruff. He can't clear it. Stolen away by the Flyers. Back out to the point, but it's taken by Randy Pierce. Pierce just coming on the ice, and it goes into the Philadelphia zone. Chasing it down there, Kevin McCarthy, number one draft pick of the Flyers in 1977. Got his first goal in the National Hockey League against the Rockies this year. Goes to Barry Beck at the goal line. We'll get an icing call here. So with 6:38 remaining in the first period, the score, Flyers 1, Rockies nothing. We'll be right back. At the Spectrum in Philadelphia, the first round of the playoffs, the Rockies trailing 1-0 in the first period. Dave Hudson on the draw against Bobby Clark, and it comes off to Andre Moose Dupont. Played for Freddie Shearer all the way back in the minor leagues at Omaha, Nebraska. Up the left wing side to Barber. Too far. Barry Beck will go back for it. Rockies take it at their own goal line, trailing on the strength of a power play goal by the Flyers. Van Boxmeer to Freddie Ahern on the right wing. Out to Hudson. Hudson at center. Van Boxmeer breaking ahead of him. It goes in behind. Bernie Berant gets by him. Into the corner to Spruce. Spruce looking for a man in front of the net, but he can't get the pass away, and Clark takes it. He's hooked and takes the puck back in behind the net. Now, Newell could have called that. Taken by Bobby Clark.
Newell hasn't called anything.
No, he's really kind of let a number of things go. He's let it, we said, he'll tend to call a very loose game, and that could be dangerous when the tempers get hot. Puck into the Colorado zone to Van Boxmeer. Johnny takes it behind the net. Over to the far boards to Andy Spruce. Spruce on the left wing. Clears it right wing side to Ahern. Ahern leads it up to Hudson. Hudson to the Philadelphia line. Ahern breaking in front of the net. They try to head man it, but he couldn't get there. Now Freddie takes it at the goal line. Wants to force a faceoff. Takes it into the boards, and it's held there. And we've got a score in. A couple of them now. Los Angeles and Toronto are tied up at one apiece. Stan Weir has scored for the Maple Leafs. And in Detroit, or in Atlanta, it's Detroit leading the Atlanta Flames on a goal by Dale McCourt. And, of course, he's the only player in the entire NHL that was drafted ahead of Barry Beck this past season. Face off to the left-hand side of Bernie Perrant. There's a look at the Flyer bench. Sellout crowd here tonight. Now we're back to action. Oucher tries to get the shot. It's blocked. Bridgman can't keep the puck, though. Forgot to take it with him. Oucher brings it back in. Trying to go around the defense. Carries it in deep. He's hooked. And the penalty call will be made as the Flyers touch the puck. Oucher was hooked. No question about it.
And it's either going to be LaPointe or Bridgman with the call. They both had their sticks on him. I think he might call it on Bridgman. I'm not sure. It could be either one of them. And Mel is skating over to the penalty bench. By the way, LaPointe is playing. Rick LaPointe in favor of Joe Watson, which some people might question since Joe has had all the playoff.
For Mel Bridgman. Time of 14 minutes, 34 seconds.
And Joe Watson has had an awful lot of playoff experience, but Rick LaPointe has come along. He's gotten some ice time. He got a lot of ice time when Tommy Bladen was injured a little bit, but then when Kevin McCarthy went out with a bad knee, LaPointe got in and got a lot of ice time and impressed Fred Shearer. He's a very slow skater, but he knows what he's doing out there on the ice, and therefore Joe Watson is sitting out.
Okay, face off down to the Philadelphia zone. Bridgman off for hooking at 14:34. Duperrey will face off. Paymon on the right. Kitchen on the left. Oucher and Beck on the blue line. Thursday at McNichols Arena. Game time at 7:30. If there's a third game, we'll televise it on Channel 2 Saturday night, 6 o'clock. Which is not going to sit well with a lot of high school basketball players here. They've got a big all-star game scheduled for that night. Now the puck comes off to Oucher, trying to slash at it in front of the net. Clark gets it, lost it. Here's Oucher in close. He tries to shoot, it's blocked. Near boards to Barber. Barber up the left wing, moving on back. Clark goes to the right. Barber goes to the right circle, runs to drink it back to center, and Paymon takes it up with Duperrey. Wilt to the blue line. Duper going into the right. Paymon, left circle, in close, getting free. He's still got it. It's in front of the net. Oh, and it's just cleared away. A shot over Bernie Perrant.
Jimmy Watson got his stick on it behind Perrant in the crease and cleared it.
Boy, it looked like it was just going to roll in. Out to Kitchen at the left circle. His shot, and Perrant will cover up and hold on. Rockies with an excellent opportunity a moment ago, but no goal. Perrant appeared to be tied up and didn't have a chance on that loose puck, but now the Rockies could get it into the net quickly enough. 1:25 remaining on the power play. At the intermission, we'll have Frank Mario on, who's the Eastern scout for the Colorado Rockies. Let's look at this again. Here's Paymon being allowed to skate in remarkably close, and as you can see, it just rolled off a pair of skates and just went wide of the net as Watson came in to clear it off. We'll also have the president or the chief owner of the Colorado Rockies on at the second intermission, Jack Vickers, and what I think you'll find to be a fascinating interview. Barry Beck at the point. It's shot. It's blocked. Paymont gets it, tries to shoot. They drop it back to Beck again at the left point. He shoots. It's blocked in heavy traffic. Duperrey trying to get it to Wilf. Kitchen can't pull the trigger as Blayton ties him up. Now Duperrey at the left circle. Brings it in close, trying to take the shot. He just hit outside the net. Kitchen lost it to Blayton, and Blayton drills it down the center ice. Beck will go back for it. 1 minute to go on the power play. Rockies, though, pressing hard and coming very, very close. Oucher skated off, goes back for it around Rick McLeish. Dennison, extremely good point shot. Oh, he got the puck. McLeish took it away. Now Duperrey across his own blue line, bringing it to center. As Pierce breaking on the right wing as he comes out with Contini. Puck in behind the Philadelphia net. Picked up by Lapointe. Lapointe makes a good move around Pierce. Contini comes in on the play and can't get it. And Ross Lonsberry skates it out up the right wing. Shoots it into the Colorado end with 30 seconds on the power play. Pavel way out of the net. Over to Contini. Up the middle to Skinner. Skinner brings it up to center. Has Pierce on the right side. Into the zone. Here's Contini getting free and a head man. And the pass was too far. Contini back to the point to Beck. Big Bubba winds up. He drills it. It's blocked. Skinner belted from behind, another penalty, a delayed whistle. Then Boxmeer shoots, it's cleared by Perron, upstairs into the seat, but the Rockies are gonna have a two-man advantage for 9 seconds. 3:35 remain in the period. We'll pause with the score, Philadelphia 1, Colorado nothing. Joe Starkey and Mike Forrest, penalty call daily for cross-checking.
So for 9 seconds, Colorado has got a two-man advantage with a face-off deep in the Flyers' zone, and this could be a very important face-off for Colorado.
They can win it and keep the possession of the puck. They've got time to take advantage of that two-man advantage, but if the Flyers win it and get it out, well, then you're down to just the one-man advantage. Bobby Clark against Dave Hudson. Clark, one of the best in the league on the face-off. And Neil Armstrong telling Bobby to get behind that tee. Now it comes off to Contini, but he couldn't get any strength out, but he gets it to Beck. Beck moving down the middle, trying to find some room. Finds it to Paymon, the right circle. In deep, first penalty is over. Wilf at the goal line, coming back out in front. Drops it back to Beck at the right point. Pierce is out there with him, as you can see. And it's cleared out to center by Clark. So it's a one-man advantage, though, for Colorado, with just over 3 minutes to go in the first period. Wilf Paymon up the right wing. Shoots it into the Philadelphia zone. To the far boards, taken there by Kindrichuk. Kindrichuk and Pierce tangle. Kindrichuk gets it loose, and Orris shoots it down the ice. The big O, as they call him. Over to Barry Beck. Beck up the left wing. Here's Van Boxmeer coming out on the ice. A long shot off the arm of Perron. Goes to the goal line. Back out to the point. Contini holds it in. Beck racing along the boards, taken away by Kindrichuk. He and Contini against the boards there, and it's tied up for a faceoff with 2:42 to go in the period. Thursday night, radio only, 56 KLZ broadcast, 7:20 p.m., McNichols Arena. And if you want a ticket for that game, you're going to have to get in line tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock at McNichols Arena.
Or you could fly to Philadelphia and watch the game on television here.
Yes, right.
Whichever's easier.
Or cheaper, if the scalpers go to work. Duperrey on the faceoff for Colorado. Looking at Don Selesky skate into the Flyer bench. Duperrey has played with St. Louis, Washington, Toronto, and now the Colorado Rockies. And never has he been more valuable than he's been to this franchise the last couple of months.
And never has he unpacked a suitcase.
That's right. McLeish breaking out of his own zone, brings it out to center, up the left wing, shot down the ice, and we're down to 1 minute on the power play. Van Boxmeer behind the Colorado Rockies net. Rockies have been outshot 10-6 in the first period. Up the right wing side, Duperrey. Being checked backwards by Selesky. Back to Van Boxmeer. Now Barry Beck up the left side. Kitchen ahead of him. Back to the blue line. Kitchen holds on to that blue line. Here's in deep to Duper. He just scores! Short wrist shot that I'm surprised got by.
I think the fact that it had very little power on it is what fooled Bernie, because it was not one of your really ripping shots. He just kind of flipped it at Bernie, and I think it might have hit the ice. Let's watch it again. It may have hit the ice just before it got to him, but it did not have a lot of power on it, and these goaltenders expect power. Watch it.
Here it is, just a quick, soft shot, as Mike said, and Duperrey gets it in, and so it's tied up.
Well, two power play goals have made the difference in this game.
On the power play, the assist to Barry Beck and John Van Boxmeer.
Beck and Van Boxmeer with the assist, a power play goal, and the Rockies have tied it at one apiece. A big goal this late in the period, at 2:15 remaining. The Rockies' power play continues to be effective. Now Brian Lepley at the Colorado blue line across to Dennis Oucher. up the right wing to the Philadelphia line. Brings it in, tries to hit Klassen, but Reggie Leach will take it there. Out to center ice to Freddie Ahern. Ahern to the neutral zone, puts it back in. Goes in behind Bernie Parent. Across to the far side to Reggie Leach. Leach with a bullet shot when he lets it go. Here's Billy Barber racing up the left wing, and Oucher takes him out of the play. Barber gets the puck back. Into the corner to Freddie Ahern. To the near side, Hudson tries to force it out of the zone. It doesn't leave as the Flyers keep it in. Now to Barber. Barber back out to the point. Bobby Clark at the blue line puts it across. He thought he was offside. He would have been. A shot by Bladen. A rebound, and Lefley grabs it. And Lefley trying to clear it, but it doesn't go as the Flyers continue to hold it in. Now Lefley lost his stick. As you can see, he broke it. Back in behind the net to Hudson. Hudson looking for some room just to get it out of there as the Flyers are pushing hard right now. Want to get that lead right back. Yeah. Often a young hockey team has trouble dealing with that when a veteran team wants to come right back and get that goal on you. Hudson with a long shot at Perron with a glove save. But Tommy Bladen behind the net with a minute to go in the period. Bladen, who had 8 points against Cleveland this year. Only two other players in history have had 8 points in a game. Rocket Richard, Bert Olmstead.
Playing the first period.
Only guy to beat him, Darryl Zittler with 10, as he got 2 years ago. Barry Beck along the far boards, under a minute to go in the period. Holmgren and Spruce tie up along the board. Skinner comes in, and it's held for a faceoff with 50 seconds remaining. So the Rockies staying with the Flyers so far in the first period.
You know Bernie's going to get roasted locally here in Philadelphia for that one, because it was not a hard shot. Those are the kind you expect your goaltender to stop and keep you in a hockey game, and Duperrey just lifted it right by him, and it was such a soft shot. I think that's really what got Bernie fouled up on it, but those are the ones you got to save, and Favell's been making a lot of them tonight, and that's why Colorado's tied with the Flyers.
All right, the faceoff to the left-hand side of Doug Favell. Rick McLeish on the faceoff against Dennis Duperrey. Yeah. Faceoff at the corner. Pass to Holmgren. Oh, my. I don't know how Favell got a piece of that one. An excellent save.
See what I mean?
Up the right side to Paymont. Paymont into the Philadelphia zone. Lays it in close to Kitchen. He can't get it. Comes to Van Boxmeer. Holds it in the zone. Now the Flyers' Daly. He's checked off by Kitchen. It goes to Barry Beck with 30 seconds in the period. Shot back in. Perron way out of the net to grab it. In traffic. Decides to just hold on with 27 seconds to go. Here's Buffalo now leading the Rangers 1-0. Gilbert Perreault scoring first for the Buffalo Sabres. That figures to be Buffalo's series. I wouldn't be surprised if they could win that in two straight, actually. But you never know in a short series. Most people, of course, figuring that the Flyers are going to beat the Rockies in two straight. And you get a hot goalkeeper or somebody comes up with a key goal and suddenly it goes three games down to the wire.
Which means you and I will be back here Saturday.
And what more can I ask for out of life than to come back to Philadelphia?
That's right. I'm going to have to watch the game on television. I've got some other business to take care of.
Bobby Clark on the faceoff against Duperrey, right-hand side of Bernie Perron. 27 seconds remaining. 1-1 tie. Armstrong discussing things with Bob Daly, apparently on his positioning at the outer rim of the circle. And the faceoff comes off to Big Bob, who came over from Vancouver last year, January of 77, for McElharkey and Goodenough, who apparently wasn't. Puck comes back over to Duperrey. Backhand, and here's Paymont trying to get free in front of the net, but it's cleared back out to center. Holmgren brings it up with 12 seconds to go. To the Colorado line, goes to the right circle. Out in front of the net is Clark. He gets it at the goal line, tries to feed it out in front. It's blocked into the corner with 4 seconds to go. Tied up along the boards, and we're down to just two. So time really just for a faceoff. There's a couple of coaches in this league, Michael, that in a situation like this would pull their goalkeeper, by the way.
Most coaches wouldn't be around this league very long if they did that very often.
But it's statistically true that you cannot score a goal in 2 seconds from that end to that end.
It's not like basketball where you wait to see what happens to the shot. When the buzzer goes off, that's it. When the red light will not turn when the green light goes on.
All right, a face-off to the left-hand side of Doug Favell. Obviously, they are listening to us, Michael, because the goal is empty.
That is true.
So Fred Shero has pulled his goalkeeper. Bernie Perron is out. They're going with the extra attacker for the quick shot off the faceoff. Bobby Clark, Rick Lapointe, Paul Holmgren, Rick McLeish, Reggie Leach, and Bob Daly.
And watch him get that shot down there in that open net in 1.5 seconds.
Fred Shero would have to make up another famous saying if that happened. All right, look at all the jockeying for position. There's Clark. Off the ice, looks like a choir boy, wears his glasses. He's very myopic, he's sipping on a Coke. But on the ice, look out.
Duperrey, by the way, has had excellent success getting faceoffs from Bobby Clark, and this is quite a matchup.
And they're struggling for this one right here. There's the draw, comes off to Paymont, and the period comes to an end. So
a good even period, though.
Toronto 2-0 over Los Angeles in the first, or 2-1, and Buffalo leading the Rangers 1-0, which makes Floyd Smith very happy, who's sitting over to my left, scout and former coach of the Buffalo Sabres. Now we're ready to go at center ice. Rockies in a 1-1 tie, and in the second period, of course, Colorado going from right to left. Dennis Duperrey breaking out of the zone, tried to get it up to Klassen, but it goes too far, and we'll get an icing call here as Rick LaPointe takes it at the goal line. Rick is married, by the way, to the sister of Brad Maxwell, who was the number one draft pick of the Minnesota North Stars this year and was a line mate of Barry Beck in New Westminster. They've just listed the scoring. Thompson, Nedimansky, and Hextall have scored for Detroit in addition to Dale McCourt.
Well, Dennis always scores. Former SEAL. There are quite a few former SEALs around the league. Colorado's got a couple of them. Of course, Dennis has much traveled and spent a couple of good years in California.
In fact, when he was at Minnesota, he led the team in scoring and penalty minutes for two straight years. Did the same thing when he was with the SEALs. Faceoff down in the Colorado zone. Comes off to Duperrey, trying to clear it out to Klassen. Does not leave the zone. Now out to center to Wilf, the captain of the Rockies. 87-point season, trying to break around the defense. Hooked off by LaPointe. Now Daly across to Bridgman on the left side. Out to the middle to Daly. Daly at the blue line. Left wing pass to Kindrichuk. Puts it in on Favelle. It goes to the far boards. Van Boxmeer slashes at it. Doesn't get it. Falls on top of the puck. Flyers get it behind the net. Kindrichuk looking for a man out in front. And Paymon just won the race for the puck. The center to Klassen. Klassen up the left wing. Shoots it in on Bernie Perron. Makes the save. Leaves it for Rick LaPointe. LaPointe, a number one pick of the Detroit Red Wings in 75. Came over for four minor leaguers last season to Philadelphia, and in his first game was the number one star in a game against Colorado, by the way, last year. And the puck, apparently, I guess he just called a quick whistle, lost sight of the puck.
He did, lost sight of the puck. It actually, Don Selesky kicked it out from Ralph Klassen, but Newell's position on it, he could only see Klassen's back, so he blew the whistle.
Bobby Clark coming out on the ice. There's Pat Kelly, the coach of the Rockies. If he chewed his gum any harder before the game, I think his entire teeth would have fallen out. He's a little nervous like everybody is. The first playoff game, Pat's first year in the NHL, going right to the playoffs. That's really something. There's Shiro, the Phantom, the Fog, Mr. X, you name it. All the great quotes. He always said when they accused the Flyers of being too rough, if you want fancy skating, go watch the Ice Capades, which, by the way, is in Denver this week.
Which almost blew Denver out of a playoff game.
That's right, but very nicely, the Rockies thank them, I guarantee you, a lot. They really appreciate the fact they gave up the date on Thursday. Here's Barber with a shot. It's blocked, comes off to Bladen. Bladen getting free down the middle, into Clark. He shoots on the short side and misses. Holmgren at the goal line, taken to the boards by Ahern. Now it comes loose. Oucher trying to pick it up. Back in behind the net. Clark likes to turn the corner in this situation, but he can't get free. Near boards, back out to the point to Bladen, holds it in. Pass Clark, behind the net to Holmgren. He's got Clark out in front. Oucher tries to tie it up. Gets it free. Pass out in front, but Lepley has it and banks it only to the point. Doesn't leave. Flyers backhander. Blocked by Oucher, and Dennis skates it out of the zone to center to Hudson. Pass Bruce on the left wing. Andy into the zone. Takes the shot. Perrant got the catch and then falls on the puck and holds on. Looked like Bernie reacted a little slow there, in fact, Mike.
Well, that puck, I was almost going to mention it. Now I will, since you mentioned it yourself. Took a little bit of a curve. It came in on the right and then broke to the left. Had a little bit of a hook on it, and Bernie had to slide over to make the save. That one was a dipsy doodle.
This is Perron's 60th playoff game, by the way, and obviously there was a mistake when they said 1-1 L.A. Toronto. It's 2-0 Toronto. Stan Weir and Jerry Butler have scored for the Maple Leafs. Rockies home Thursday night at McNichols, the second game of the series. If there's a third game, it's here Saturday night at 8 o'clock, 6 o'clock broadcast in the Rocky Mountain region on KWGN-TV Channel 2. Greg Hale Thursday on KLZ.
If Ricky turned around in that shot, you'd see those stitches up on down the side of his neck, but he's facing the wrong way.
I haven't seen a set of stitches like that since Boris Karloff in Frankenstein. Larry Skinner against McLeish.
Tell him you said that.
Barry Beck out to the point. Goes in front of the net, and the Flyers grab it. Rick McLeish. McLeish out to center ice, back to Barry Beck. Back at his own blue line. And the Flyers grab it in the neutral zone. Taken by McLeish on the left wing. Shoots it in behind Favelle. Doug knocks it down, leaves it for Beck. There's nobody on earth that Favelle would like to beat out of the playoffs more than these guys. He's got a lot of friends on this team, but wouldn't it be satisfying for him to beat the Flyers, the team he spent so many years with? Barry Beck in his own zone, across to Van Boxmeer. 1-1 tie early in the second period. Boxy, a 70-foot shot off the glass. Near side, Skinner trying to grab possession. Goes to Reggie Leach. To the fireboards. Van Boxmeer at the point, but he can't get possession. Now the Flyers have trouble clearing it out, though, as Boxy ties it up nicely. Boy, he's really played well for the Rockies this year. He's underrated yet. You know, a lot of people think of him as just that spare that was playing for the Canadians all those years. But since he's played regular for the Rockies, he's been superb. Puck goes into the Colorado zone. Joe Contini at the fireboards and flips it down the ice, and Daly will chase it down. Daly, a gourmet cook, and he ought to be to fill up that 6'5" frame. He better know what he's doing. He's going to kill himself with food poisoning. Goes back to Van Boxmeer at the Colorado line. Johnny back out to center to Klassen. Klassen to the neutral zone. He's poked away by Daly. Now to Skinner. Skinner can't keep it. Klassen shoots it in, and it goes in on Perron. 1-1 tie in the second period. A sellout crowd as usual at the Spectrum. To center ice. Down the left wing side, breaking into the zone is Bridgman. Tries to headman it out in front. Duperre clears it back to center. Now Jimmy Watson, younger brother of Joe, from Smithers, British Columbia, small town 500 miles north of Vancouver. Puck in behind the Colorado net. Fans making noise. They want to see the Flyers shake it up here, but now the Rockies have possession. Duperre on the left wing. Paymont breaking at center. A pass into Wilf. Carries it into the zone, and Klassen was a step offside. So 3.5 minutes gone here in the second period. We'll pause with a score tied at 1. Neutral zone faceoff. Second period, 1-1 tie. Joe Starkey and Mike Forrest. Spectrum in Philadelphia. And the faceoff comes off to Mike Christie. Christie on the left side. Shoots it in behind the Philadelphia net. Grabbed there by the Philadelphia Flyers. 1-1 tie and a much more cautious second period so far than we had in the first. Flyers in the neutral zone. Right wing side to Kindrachuk. Kindrachuk into the Colorado zone, trying to beat Christie. Goes to the circle. Drops it back out to Bladen. Winds up his shot. It's blocked by Pavel superbly in front of the net. Mike Christie grabs it. Out to center ice. And it's taken by Selesky. Selesky back on the right wing. Shoots it in. Goes wide to the far boards. Doucher. Over to Wilf. Wilf being chased by Kindrachuk. Wants to get it out. It didn't leave. Held in. Now Paymont battling for it at the right circle and gets a Doucher. Oucher coming over from Pittsburgh early in the year for Tommy Edger. Oucher into the Philadelphia zone at the right circle. Taken hard into the boards and taken away by Mel Bridgman. Bridgman shoots it to center and Christie backing up on defense. Boys, Mike had some run-ins with this team. I'll tell you, he's had some classic brawls with the entire Philadelphia Flyer team. Oucher on the right wing side. Back to Bobby Clark. Clark at the Philadelphia blue line. Brings it up to center. The captain of the MVP three times in the NHL. Goes over to the far boards. Dennis Duperre in behind the deck. Over to the near side to Andy Spruce. Spruce out to center ice. And the Flyers' Andre Dupont. The Moose has it in the neutral zone. Billy Barber puts it back in. Now Christie at the goal line. Takes a check from Clark. Got him on the shoulder, too. You got to worry about that. That's where he's hurt. Now at the goal line. A feed out in front. A shot. And oh, just off, appeared off the shoulder almost of Pavel, just wide. Duperre clears it down ice. And the Flyers will back up for it. We'll get an icing call here unless Spruce wins the race, which he won't. Kevin McCarthy gets there.
I'll tell you, Joe, Billy Barber was set up beautifully. He leveled that shot. He really picked his corner. I hope we're going to see a replay of that one. We may or may not. We don't have any control over the video here tonight. This is provided locally by the Philadelphia people, but Barber had it absolutely leveled, and I don't know how Pavel stopped that one.
Well, there's a lot of sports going on in Philadelphia tonight. Right next door, the Phillies are playing the Montreal Expos before their usual big crowd. The Phillies will probably draw 2 million this year. Great sports town these days. If they can just straighten out the Eagles, they got it made.
I don't know that that'll ever happen, Joe.
Dave Hudson against Rick McLeish, right-hand side of Doug Pavel. And Boxmeer and Beck on defense, 4 and 5. Spruce number 22, Ahern 24. Boxy at the far boards in his own zone. Flyers grab the puck. Here's Kelly behind the net trying to jam it in. Pavel anticipating, forced it off his stick. Hudson behind the net and Kelly. Kelly knocks him off the puck. Now it rolls in under Dave, comes loose to Ahern. Freddie breaking out the right wing at 15 points in the last 16 games of the year in that closing drive by Colorado. Hearn with a long shot. Over to Daly. Daly over to Kelly. Kelly out to the point and out to center ice. Spruce grabbing at it there. Comes back to Kelly. Take him to the Flyers and shot in behind Doug Pavel. 5.5 minutes gone in the second period in a 1-1 tie. McLeish out in front, but Barry Beck has it. Beck out to Hudson. Ahern breaking on the right wing. Brings it in. Trying to get free. Back to Hudson, but Daly clears it away. Now Daly back to center ice, moving left to right. At the blue line, right wing pass to Dornhofer, out for the first time, and he went for the short side, and save made, and Dorney running hard into Barry Beck. And Mike, you might want to talk about what Sunday night was all about here with Dornhofer.
That was Gary Dornhofer night. Fans in Colorado might not know it, but Gary Dornhofer is hanging him up after this season. He announced it quite a while ago. And after 11 years as a Philadelphia Flyer, and I quite honestly have to say, nobody except maybe Bobby Clark has given more of his body to this team than Gary Dornhofer. He's broken just about every kind of bone you can break in your body. He has leveled people. He has been leveled. He has given his all, and the fans gave him his night here at the last regular season game. And to see a Gary Dornhofer standing at center ice crying like a baby, I'll tell you, that's some sight.
And he's already back off the ice, though, right now. Doug Pavel playing in his 20th playoff game here with the Colorado Rockies, of course, for the first time. Rick McLeish against Larry Skinner, a fifth-round pick of the Rockies in 76, and the first man ever to score a goal in McNichols Arena in the regular season. McLeish, big gun. He can really fire it, but sometimes he's not quite sure himself where it's going to go. Puck behind to Brian Lefley, far side to Oucher. Oucher hit from behind, trying to get it clear over to Pierce. Pierce, Contini, and Skinner. This line really hums, particularly at home ice. And, of course, rookies in the league, young players like this, sometimes have trouble playing quite the same game on the road. Now Contini shoots it into the Philadelphia zone. Pierce racing for it there. Oh, way out of the net comes Perrant. They fight for it in the corner. Contini trying to get it out to Pierce, but taken away by the Flyers. Now Lonsberry. Lonsberry can't get it out. Rockies hold it in. Flyers keep it in. Back in behind the net. Over to Bladen. Bladen trying to clear the zone. Has Leach on the right wing, and Reggie starts to bring it out from Flynn Flon. The Flynn Flon juniors were his teammate at Clark. Drills it from the blue line, and Favell with a good save on a hard shot. Oucher out to Skinner. Skinner lets it roll to center ice. And going back for it, Bladen. Bladen clears it back into the neutral zone. 1-1 tie, second period, 13 minutes remaining. Whoa, you hear that crunch along the boards? Right into the microphone area where we have one over there. Puck goes to the goal line. Lefley can't get it from McLeish. They try to pass to Leach, and he couldn't control it. Now to Skinner. Skinner along the boards. Skinner under pressure, and Lefley has to come in to help, and the Flyers keeping the puck now in the Colorado end. Skinner comes up with a loose puck, drops it back behind the net to Brian Lefley. Lefley spent a lot of the year playing at left wing. Leach with a steal, has a man open, trying to bring it in, kneeling down, feeds it to McLeish, and brings it back out to the right point to Bladen, hits it on the move at the side of the net to McLeish. A shot, a save, a rebound, it's still loose. Rockies get it back to Contini, who clears it to Pierce.
Fantastic save on Rick McLeish's shot. I don't know how Favell got up and around on that one, but he is having one heck of a night.
That's what we were talking about, and Mike mentioned it earlier, that the key maybe for the Rockies to pull an upset in this series is a superb game by Favell. Now Van Boxmeer at the Colorado line. Around the boards, Bridgman grabs it. Trying to get it to McCarthy at the point, but Klassen with a good effort forces the puck, and it goes down to the Philadelphia zone. No icing, washed out by Claude Béchard. Far boards there, Kindrichuk back out to center. Now Bridgman on the left wing, fires it in to the near boards. Racing for it there, Klassen and Zaleski. Behind the net to Barry Beck. Pokes it around to Van Boxmeer. John back out to the point and beyond to the Philadelphia under the ice. Zandruff is back on for the first time in a while. Chasing that puck. Flyers in the neutral zone. 1-1 tie, 8 minutes gone in the second period. Fired on the right wing, in behind Favell. Pace of the game, quite different here than it was in the first period. Back out to the left point. Shot in behind the net. Zaleski getting free there, but DeLorme catches up with him. A feed out in front, a shot behind the net. The Chief tangling behind the net, trying to get in possession of the puck. Beck comes in out, and they tie it up. 11:29 remain in the second period. We'll pause with a score tied at one. 11:29 remaining in the second period at the Spectrum in Philadelphia, the best of three series. And we're almost halfway through this hockey game, and it's a very tight battle.
Joe, I think maybe Fred Chiaro has changed a little bit of strategy on that last call down the ice. He had all three forwards way deep. In fact, they all wound up behind the net, which is a heck of a way to try and score. But if he's going to send that many men in deep, if Colorado can pop it out real quick, they can be on a break.
Clark will take the faceoff of the Philadelphia Flyers. Bobby, of course, a diabetic, and many people in Denver are not that well tuned into hockey might be surprised to hear that. But he is. He has to take 55 units a day, a shot of insulin. They keep very syrupy soft drinks on the bench for him during a game, but it has never affected his play. Doug Favell, right off the faceoff, just holds on to it there. That's one of the reasons, the only reason, that Clark was not a first-round pick, because he was drafted 17th by the Flyers back in 69, and everybody else just assumed because he was a diabetic, in spite of his junior record, that he couldn't make it. The Flyers are the only ones that had sense enough to make a simple phone call to the doctor, have their doctor check him out, and found out there's no reason he can't play. Ron Santo's done it. There have been a number of top athletes that have done it. And in fact, I just read about somebody lately, Mike, if you can remember for me. Somebody that we just learned about a few weeks ago, some pro athlete that just found out he had diabetes.
That does strike a familiar bell, but I can't remember the song.
Okay. Favell with another save off the faceoff.
By the way, they say Clark, he's in the best shape ever going into a playoff series. The last 4, 5, or 6 years, he has been so run down from the season, not because of his diabetes, but simply because of the style of play. Yeah. But he had a fractured thumb and sat out 3 weeks, and he's really ready to go.
So that really did him some good, you can say. Although it probably cost the Flyers first place, too. Faceoff, Flyers in deep, a backhander, Favell, a fine save. Again, just staying with it. Those backhanders, of course, they swing on you, and they're very tough to stay with. Duperrey in his own zone. Over to Kitchen. Mike Kitchen wearing the horse collar around his neck to protect possible damage. He's had trouble with the back and the neck on various times in his 2 years with the Rockies. Flyers in their own zone. Selesky, but it comes back out to center to Kitch. Across ice to Van Boxmeer. Johnny with a 56-point season. A superb year for the Colorado Rockies. 12 goals. Oh, almost a hooking there. Kitchen grabbing one of the Flyers and gets a slash back from DuPont. Flyers put it in on Favelle. Comes in front of the net. Doug clears it back out to center ice. Favelle's really in the game tonight, and that's a good example right there. When he's on that puck like that, he's really on top of his game. Puck out to center ice. Cleared away. Here's Paymon on the right wing. He's got Daly to beat. Brings it in. Goes to the right circle. Tries to get a shot away, but he's taken hard into the boards by Daly, who slashes him, and now they're going at it against the boards. 6'5", Bob Daly against Will Paymon, as Daly, reacting to Paymon, slashed him with a stick, then dropped the gloves, and they start swinging.
Well, to be totally honest, Joe, there was a little bit on both sides before they went. They went into the boards. Paymon hit Daly as he turned away, and Daly came back and slashed him. And we've got a little bit of the bear dance, a little bit of hugging going on there against the boards, not much fighting.
Yep, we've got Holmgren holding on to Barry Beck over in the corner of the action. And the main confrontation, though, Big Bob Daly and Barry Beck. And Daly, of course, with that enormous size at 6'5". But we'll get some penalties here. You can count on that, no question about it. And while they dole them out, we'll take a commercial break with a score tied at one apiece. Okay, we're back at the Spectrum in Philadelphia. You can hear Dave Newell. Paymon for high sticking and fighting.
We got him for roughing and fighting.
That's going to even out, Joe.
Coincidental, everything's coincidental.
So 2-5 to each of them.
Yep.
Daly got a roughing and a 5-minute fighting, and Paymon got a, what was that, a high sticking and a fighting.
2 minutes for high sticking plus 5 minutes for fighting.
So the penalties will be 7 minutes apiece, of course, and since they're majors and coincidental, the players,
5 minutes for
there's
fighting.
That great save by Favelle, by the way. Look at that come off his hand there.
That was a shot from Kindrachuk, a backhand, and those backhand shots are really difficult to stop, but I'll tell you, Favelle is playing a game tonight that the Flyers might wish they still had him.
For the Flyers.
So it's one apiece. The penalties are majors to Daly and Paymon. 9:33 of the second period. Everybody looking for their equipment now, and the teams will remain at full strength, of course, with major penalties. Thursday night, McNichols Arena, game time at 7:30, and tickets go on sale to the general public tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. If there's a third game, it's right here on Saturday night at 8 o'clock, 6 o'clock Denver time on KWGN-TV, Channel 2 in Denver. Got a few Rocky fans in the building tonight, not too many, but a few people came up before the game to say hello and said they were here. Detroit now leading Atlanta 4-1 as Guy Chouinard has now scored for the Atlanta Flames, but it's a long way to come back. And of course, you lose that home ice advantage is really significant in a three-game series, and that's why as this game rolls along here, the Rockies staying in it, this could really be something. Buffalo now 2-0 over the Rangers. They say Martin got a goal, but they have a Rick and they have a Terry, so we don't know who that is, but I would assume
Rick.
Rick is the likely choice.
Richard.
Terry just got his third goal, I think, in the last game of the season, if I'm not mistaken, Sunday night in Buffalo.
Well, I'll tell you, Joe, something like that, I wonder if that'll spark the Flyers or the Rockies, because I think Daly went after Paymon. Paymon didn't hit him too hard when he came off the boards, but it was almost as if Daly said, well, I got to do something to get this team going against a team like Colorado, and he took a swipe at him.
So a face-off in the Philadelphia zone. Dave Hudson knocked to the ice off the play, and the Flyers start to bring it out. Ross Lonsberry up the right wing to the Colorado line. Christie takes him into the boards and out of the play. Puck goes to Oucher. Oucher gets it back up the left wing to Andy Spruce. Spruce has a hurt in the middle. Andy takes fires into the zone. Bernie Perrant way out of the net, clears it to the boards to McLeish. McLeish out to Oucher. A shot! There's a hurt in front of the net! He carried it in behind him. He couldn't get out of his clothing. Hudson's got Spruce out in front. Instead, tries to feed it to the point, but it didn't get there. Now McLeish up the right wing. Pass on the left side to Lonsberry. Lonsberry drops it to the point, and here's a Hearn with a two-on-one with Spruce. Gets it to Andy. Freddie trying to get back into the play. Had all his momentum the other way. A shot wide. Hearn at the right circle. Puts it back in behind the net to Spruce. Spruce looking for a man out in front. The shot is blocked, though. Now they tangle behind the net. A Hearn coming in on the play with Lonsberry. Freddie trying to give it to Hudson. Hudson gets it out to the point. Here's Oucher winding up. He drills it. Save! Oh, and the rebound picked off by Philadelphia. Flyers bring it back in a 1-1 tie. Shot in, deflects and goes just to the goal line to Ralph Klassen. Klassen for Colorado coming out. Hearn on the right wing. Skinner at center right now, the middle of a line change. We got a penalty call coming up. Freddie Hearn is going to be called for holding.
Well, I think Orris Kinderchuk took advantage of a situation. He saw he had a little bit of daylight. He was trying to get through Auchard and Ahern, and he put a little bit of an act on, and I think he drew the penalty, but somebody's going to get the gate. It might even, well, Ahern is going to get it. Could have been either he or Auchard, and Fred got the holding penalty.
So Freddie goes out of the penalty box. Here's the call.
Fred Ahern, 2 minutes for holding. Time, 10 minutes, 47 seconds.
And with two power play goals in this game already, that could be significant.
That's right. Each team scoring with the power play advantage, so that could be the difference in this game yet tonight, because it has become a very close-checking affair here in the second period. Duperrey, an excellent face-off man for Colorado, but he's going against the Flyers' best, too, Bobby Clark. Rick McLeish looking for a new weapon over at the Flyers bench. I guess when we're talking about the Flyers, weapon is the appropriate term. Only kidding.
Folks. I'm not going to talk
no,
about
I
that.
No, I wouldn't say that.
I mean, I have to stay here when you leave, remember?
So Duperrey on the face-off against Clark.
These guys know where to find me.
Yes, well, I hope so. Not me. Holmgren on the right wing, McLeish on the left, and Barber and Kevin McCarthy on the blue line. 1-1 tie, second period, but a big moment of the game now, a power play. Van Boxmeer under pressure from Clark. Always working that stick, and Klassen gets it and shoots it down the ice. Barber will chase it down. Billy Barber in front of his own net, over to the near side to Kevin McCarthy, out to Holmgren, who was born in St. Paul, Minnesota, went to the University of Minnesota with the Gophers, played a year in the WHA before coming to the Flyers. Clark at the point, into McLeish. He's checked off the puck, but gets it over to McCarthy at the right circle. McCarthy leading out in front, a shot at Pavel! Oh! Tremendous pressure, a close-in shot, and no goal.
Billy Barber again. That's the second time Pavel's made a move on him. Barber called for the puck. Kevin McCarthy saw it and laid it across, but I think at the same time Pavel saw Barber and he was able to kind of hone in on him. And Barber again picked his corner and couldn't hit it.
Watch this play now. Here's the perfect feed, the perfect setup. There's your player with the shot. And somehow, Pavel held on.
You'll notice, though, that Pavel's body was already turned to Barber. He anticipated that pass, and he spotted Barber, and that's what made the good play on his part.
Now the Flyers out to Barber. He shoots, and it goes through the crease. Near boards to McCarthy. McCarthy into the right circle to Clark. Clark has it there. That's Holmgren right in front of it as the Rockies back into a box defense. Out to the point to McCarthy. Over to Barber, left point. Clark going into the middle. Back to McCarthy. Barber again takes the shot. Deflected by Duperrey up into the seats. Power play has 1:10 to go. Ahern is off for holding. We've got a 1-1 tie. And we're more than halfway through this hockey game. First round of the playoffs in a sudden death almost three-game series, because that's quick and dirty. You can end in a hurry, and you just don't get that chance to come back when it's only three games. There are many teams that might come out with a three-game win in a three-game series, but would never have a chance, let's say, in a seven-game series against somebody that would just wear them down. Rocky's in a change here now, as you saw, and so now Hudson is out with Andy Spruce, Oucher, and Barry Beck. Little discussion at the bench. Kevin McCarthy. I always think of Invasion of the Body Snatchers when I hear that. Did you ever see that movie?
Yes,
classic,
I did.
Where the pea pods turn into people? Kevin McCarthy was the star of that one.
By the way, this is Kevin McCarthy's first ever playoff game in the Stanley
That's
Cup
right.
Series.
Rookie in the NHL. Neil Armstrong drops the puck, and it comes back to the point to Barber. Over to McCarthy, trying to get a shot away, and Hudson or Spruce couldn't get control. Back to Clark at the right circle. Drops it back out to Kevin. At the blue line, McCarthy into Clark again. Has Holmgren in front of the net. Instead, out to Barber, down the middle. Hudson trying to pick him up, getting in close. A shot, oh, dribbles off a couple of legs to the near boards. And Spruce can't clear it. McCarthy doing a fine job of holding into the zone. Now the Flyers back in possession again. Holmgren moving in, getting free, backhands it. Bounces off of Beck, and Favell coming out of the net to get it to the far boards. Beck looking for the loose puck. He can't get it. Clark. Clark at the side of the net, right out in front. They try to shoot. It's loose. Favell diving on the puck with about four other players. And again, the Rockies hold the fort.
I'll tell you that Doug Favell tonight has looked so fantastic. And his defense, on occasion like there, they took down everybody in front of the net. They took Clark down. He's still lying in the crease. Now watch him clear everybody out. Clarkie with the puck behind the net, looking for somebody to pass to. Just dumps it in front. Watch Holmgren with the helmet on. He gets taken out. His legs get sliced from him. Clarkie goes down. And there we got a nice pileup of bodies.
So the score remains at one apiece. 31 seconds on the power play. And the faceoff in the Colorado zone.
As soon as they patch up the ice, I think one of the Rockies is buried underneath there. They got to dig him out.
Right.
Bart Bayshard might want to play some hockey. He's got about three sticks in his hand now. They're all broken. Twisted, torn bodies and sticks.
So DuPerry back out for the faceoff, the right-hand side of Doug Favell. Beck and Van Boxmeer will be on defense. Ralph Klassen up there as a forward. Klassen pretty much a defensive forward anyhow. Humboldt, Saskatchewan native. Number one draft pick of the California Seals in 75. From the faceoff to Beck, and Beck gets it out of the zone, down the ice with 25 seconds to go on the power play. Bernie Perron out of the net to give it to Rick Lapointe. Lapointe quickly back up to center as the Flyers break up the middle. 1-1 tie. Lonsberry, Colorado line, goes to the right circle, drops it to Leach. Leach has a man in front of the net, Kindrachuk. Rocky's backing up. Back out to the point, Bladen. Bladen winds up for a shot. It comes off to Leach at the right circle. Backhands it again to Bladen. Bladen to Reggie, and he puts it in behind the net to Lonsberry with 1 second to go. Penalty over, but the Flyers in close, trying to get the shot away. Here's Lapointe behind the net. Here's Reggie. Reggie winds up. Oh, and it bounced off of Favell, and I hope he's okay the way it went down there, but it went up in the air over him.
I'll tell you, Reggie Leach has not had a good season. You mentioned it a little bit earlier, Joe, and he has sat out almost as much as he's played. He has wanted to shoot that puck and get it on net, and he was just not about to pass it right there. Watch this shot.
Oh, never hit Reggie. Apparently the Rocky player in front of the net deflected it and sent it upstairs. But Reggie, as you say, Mike, only 24 goals this year, 28 assists, compared to a guy who had 61 2 years ago and 45 the year before that.
He is going through an entire head trip. He doesn't know why he's not being played. He's letting his physical condition get to him a little bit, and he's getting a little bit heavier than he was during his better years. And all in all, he's just not having a good year.
That close-up was Orris Kindrachuk, by the way, on the Flyers. There's DuPont at the right circle. He shoots in traffic, and it hit Kelly. He couldn't get it through him. Now Oucher at the near boards. Skinner battling for it. Comes back to Dennis. Oucher and Selesky along the boards. Behind the net to Bridgman, being raced by Lefley. Lefley fighting for the puck. The Flyers. Here's Selesky, but he couldn't hold it on his stick. Rocky's still under enormous pressure from Philadelphia. Kelly out in front. And, oh, Favell had to grab it as it came from behind the net and hold on. My, oh, my. Okay, let's take a break. 6:43 to go in the period. It's tied at one. Larry Skinner out on the faceoff of the Colorado Rockies. A young player who spent much of the first two seasons in professional hockey in the minor leagues, but has come up in critical situations, and particularly late here this season, has really been a big factor in the drive for the playoffs. The puck stays in the Colorado zone. At the left point to Jimmy Watson, a shot blocked as Pierce tried to slide underneath it. Goes back into the corner. Flyers' Mel Bridgman at the left circle. And the Flyers more and more, though, keeping the puck in the Colorado zone. Rockies here now. Pierce breaking on the right wing. He breaks into the zone. Contini coming in. Oh, and the pass just underneath him. Joe keeps it in the zone, but it rolls away to Bridgman. Pierce right on top of him. Skinner, Pearson, Contini. A great combination for Colorado. Pierce a third-round pick. Contini a seventh. Skinner a fifth. And yet they have been a big factor in the Rockies' second half. Puck into the Colorado zone. Oucher racing forward at the goal line. Takes it there on the right wing. Feeds it out to Pierce. Pierce looking for Skinner up the middle. Contini to the left. Randy shoots it in. Oh, hits the back of the net. Going back toward DuPont. DuPont lost it to Skinner. Over to the far boards, and the Flyers have room to bring it out. They carry it out to center. Bridgman on the left wing. Moving on Van Boxmeer. Trying to go around him, but Randy Pierce grabs the puck and shoots it down the ice. Looks like it might not even get to the guess. It is. It's going to get there for an icing call, and so we'll have a whistle here. Remember now, you can call right now 534-PUCK, 534-PUCK for season ticket information. And for as little as $25 down, which you can charge on your Master Charger Visa by just giving them your number, you can line up a season ticket for next year and get those low priority numbers for playoff tickets. For example, the season ticket holders purchased a tremendous amount of tickets for this playoff game on Thursday night. They were entitled to double their allotment, and they all used them, apparently, from what we've heard. So look at it tomorrow morning. Get in that line early, 8 a.m. The box office open at McNichols for that Thursday night playoff game against Philadelphia. Gary Dornhofer, his last game last night for the Philadelphia Flyers in the regular season. And now back to the ice action, Dennis DuPerry and Bobby Clark. Faceoff comes out to Barber. Barber shoots! Good save again by Favell. And Kitchen clears it to DeLorme, who's back out now. Fourth line combination, really, for the Rockies right now, using DeLorme on the right wing, Kitchen on the left side, and DuPerry in the middle. DeLorme in the Colorado zone. Back out to center and taken by Rick Lapointe. 5.5 minutes to go in the second period. It's tied at one. Puck rolls to Van Boxmeer at the goal line. John clears it out to DuPerry. Brings it up 3-on-2. Left wing pass to Kitchen. Kitchen overskated the puck, and the Flyers have it again. Bobby Clark across ice. Trying to bring it up. DeLorme gets the puck away to DuPerry. Duper circling at center ice. Flips it in on Perron. Bouncing in. Ooh, those are tough sometimes to get on their side, and they do a knuckleball on you. Back over to Clark. Clark up the middle. 1-1 tie. Across the blue line. Going to try to do it himself. Going in deep, and he shoots it wide. Near boards, DeLorme racing forward with Barber. Comes out through the crease. Here's LaPointe at the circle. He shoots, and it's over the net. Near boards and back out to the point. Taken by Tommy Bladen. Bladen across ice to LaPointe. Into the middle to Barber. Barber and Hudson, but it goes into Barry Beck. Beck has it in a 1-1 tie. Back out to center. Good knockdown by Hudson. Hudson trying to put it on the right wing, but the Flyers take it away. Now Rick McLeish back out to center. Beck has it. Beck in the neutral zone, in control of the puck. Shoots it in, and it goes in behind Bernie Perron. Perron leaves it there for Rick LaPointe. LaPointe from Victoria, British Columbia. Back out to Christie. He shoots it wide. Bounces out in front. Spruce tangling against the boards. Ahern coming in on the play. It's tied up for a faceoff. So 4:06 remain in the period. We'll pause with the score tied. Flyers 1 to the Rockies 1. A 1-1 tie. The second period, 4 minutes and 6 seconds remaining. The Rockies goal on the night was scored by Dennis Duperrey and McLeish for the Flyers. Hudson on the faceoff, and the puck goes behind the Philadelphia net. DuPont around the boards, out to the point. Oucher has trouble with it, though. Keeps it in. Gets it to Ahern. They say he didn't keep it in. Neil Armstrong says no way.
Tell you, Joe, the key to this game, we've been saying, is Doug Favell, and I don't think anything points that up more than when we look at the shot board. They keep a running total of shots here. So far, the Flyers have outshot the Rockies 22-12, and a lot of those 22 were so difficult, and Favell was able to handle all but one, but there's the story right there.
Face off in the neutral zone. Dave Hudson started in the Blackhawk organization from North Dakota University, played with the Islanders, and playing for the first time in the National Hockey League playoffs. Now Oucher pops it in on Perron, comes way out of the net to grab it there and leaves it behind the net. Running out of time in the second period in a 1-1 tie. Now McLeish with a good move, brings it to center, right wing to Leach, a little bit too far. In behind Favell, Reggie racing for the puck. At the far boards, Christie staying with him. Here's McLeish, he drills it, and again Favell makes the save. Back to center to Reggie. Leach in the neutral zone. Drops it back on defense. And trying to bring it up, the Flyers' Kevin McCarthy. Pass into Leach. Leach apparently was offside, and he was. Back and forth across the blue line. And
he took himself offside. He was on the wrong side of the blue line, and he reached back for the puck and brought it across. That's a no-no.
You bet. So a change of lines completely now for both teams. Flyer bench. You know, Freddie Shiro is famous for all his quotes. A couple of my most favorite ones as we watch the replay on this shot is Reggie offside, as he believes that life is just a place where you spend time between games, Michael. Dedicated coach. One of my all-time favorites is, if you walk with your head in the clouds and keep your feet on the ground, you can make $1 million in the NBA.
I think you made that one up.
No, I wouldn't do that. All right, neutral zone faceoff, 1-1 tie, 3.5 minutes remaining second period. We'll have Jack Vickers, the principal owner of the Rockies, on at the intermission, and Jacques Plante, a great goalkeeper for many years in the NHL with the Montreal Canadiens, Toronto Maple Leafs. Now the Flyers into the Colorado end. Van Boxmeer forcing it out to Pearson. Randy up the right wing, has Bladen in front of him, goes to the right circle, winds up, drills it. Oh, Perron had trouble with that one, but he makes the save, and off to Jimmy Watson. Watson across his own blue line to center, carries it up with Kitchen backing up on him. Puck goes in behind Favell. Favell clears it to the near boards. Holmgren trying to get it loose away from Kitchen. Back out to the point. Doesn't leave the zone as Bladen holds it in. Pass Clark around the boards to Van Boxmeer. Johnny at the goal line. Flips it out up in the air and up into the seats. So it went back out on the ice, though, and so a faceoff. And Bayshard decides to give the puck away. And a faceoff in the Colorado zone. Van Boxmeer, of course, was the story of a great controversy in the Canadian Stanley Cup win 2 years ago. He and Don Aury were on the Canadiens roster but never played a minute in the Stanley Cup playoffs. And although they were carried on the team and had to sit out all those games, many people felt they should have their name on the cup anyhow because they've been with the team all year and played regularly. But because they weren't in the playoffs, they wouldn't put their name on the cup.
That's
and so big
stinky.
Disappointment. Yeah,
that's
I think so.
That's
too.
Really kind of stinky. But you never can tell these people in Montreal. That's the way they are. That's what Scotty Bowman told me.
Vive la France. Yes. All right, Duperrey on the faceoff. Right-hand side of Favell against Orris Kindrichuk, a free agent. Came to this team in 71. 1-1 tie and less than 3 minutes to go in the second period in the first game of this three-game playoff series. Now the puck to center. Paymite couldn't get it. Daly shoots it back in. Favell has done a superb job tonight. From Van Boxmeer to the near boards to Mike Kitchen and by him, and Daly will chase it down to the Philadelphia zone. Big Bob Daly, number one pick of Vancouver in 73. Back in behind Favell. Doug stops it behind the net, leaves it for Beck over to the right side to Wilf. Paymont can't clear it. Flyers hold it in. Shot behind the net. Now the Flyers trying to get an opportunity out in front of the net, and so Van Boxmeer wants to land on the puck and does. And this time, though, he kept his hands off it.
No, he didn't. He scooted that underneath. I could see that hand reach out and scoot it underneath him. He is very, very big with the hands tonight.
Johnny, as we said, has really done a good job for this team. His first chance to play regularly in the NHL since coming over last November from Montreal. And last year, of course, handicapped by knee injuries most of the year. But boy, has he done the job for the Rockies this season. Team mostly with Barry Beck, 54-point season. All his goals coming in the last two-thirds of the year, too, by the way. Couldn't find the net in the first third, and all of a sudden, bang, it started going in for him. Now the faceoff. The Flyers grab it in the Colorado zone. Back out to Daly. Daly winds up. The shot is blocked. Kitchen grabs it, banks it out to center. Oh, and Daly intercepts. Back across ice, overskated it, and shot back in by Philadelphia. Now Favelle leaves it for Beck. Back to the left wing to Kitchen. Kitchen clears it again. Daly, though, keeps it in, doing a good job of holding that puck in the Colorado zone. Now the Rockies get it to center. Under 2 minutes in the period, and they're going to call, apparently, the stick deflection, the high stick on that one, knocking the puck down, and so a faceoff will be called with less than 2 minutes to go in the period. There's big Robert, and, of course, he rates right up with the Oakland Raiders as the most unpopular type in Denver right now after a Paul Gardner incident in January when he grabbed Paul at the blue line, slid him all the way into the boards, and the main objection was that there was no penalty called at all. And Daly, certainly his intention was not to hurt Gardner, but he's got a lot of size and a lot of momentum. Right side to Ahern, to the Philadelphia line, brings it in, has trouble with the puck, keeps it in though, shoots it in deeper, Hudson grabbing it there. Dave along the far boards. Now the Flyers pick it up and shoot it back to Bob Kelly. Kelly stirs things up when he gets out on the ice. Back in the neutral zone to Lonsberry. Shoots it in by Brian Lepley. Minute and a half to go in the period. Lepley around the boards to Oucher. Oucher can't get it out. Lonsberry holds it in with Kelly at the side of the net. Bobby going to try to jam it in around in front. He puts it out in front. Nobody there. Spruce to Ahern. Freddie up the middle with Bladen back. Takes a long shot. Perron, a head-high save. Leaves it for Tommy Bladen. Out the fireboards. Hudson trying to intercept, can't get it. Out to McLeish. McLeish, a right wing pass to Kelly. Good maneuver. The right wing into the Colorado zone, but Spruce took it away. Spruce out to Hudson. Hudson to the blue line. To Ahern on the right wing. He drills it. Oh, and Perron dropped it, but it went wide. Back to the near boards to Kelly. Bob Kelly for the Flyers with 54 seconds remaining in the period, and the Rockies putting on a sudden surge here. Flyers can't clear. Stays in at the point. Now the Flyers have it. Kelly with 45 seconds to go. Brings it into the middle. Hudson just out, hustles in for the puck, and it goes back to Lonsberry. Rockies are on their feet in their bench. They are really into this game. Now the Flyers in deep to Leach. Look out! He shoots, and a good save by Favelle. As again, Doug plays into a goal! 20 seconds remaining in the period. Boy, that's a big goal.
Bobby Clark on it, Joe. He was standing right on the corner of the crease. Favelle had made two fantastic saves. The puck went around the net. Clark, he was there, and he just backhanded it in.
19:31 of the second period, and that is really a demoralizing goal for Colorado.
Beautiful save on that other one by Jimmy Watson. Bobby There's Clarky, and he just slides it into the far side.
So Favelle did everything he could. He made a great save on the first shot and raced like crazy to get to the other end. But Clark, anticipating that Favelle had to slide across, very wisely just put it up a little bit, enough to get it over Doug Favelle.
The assist to Rich Leach and Jimmy Watson.
Leach and Watson with the assist. So it's 2-1 Philadelphia. And as we say, you just can't overemphasize the importance of a goal in a game this tight with less than a minute to go in the period. Now Van Boxmeer at the Colorado goal line. He's checked off the play. Clark trying to get it away from him. Now Johnny has it. Brings it up the right wing. Trying to get it to Duperrey, but Clark with a steal. Shoots it back into Barber. Just 10 seconds remaining. Barber down the middle. He shoots wide. Goes to Clark. Puts it out in front. And oh, they almost had another one on a deflection with just a second to go. And we're going to get a faceoff with exactly 1 second remaining. That, as we say, a big factor here. The Rockies now have to play the third period considerably different than they would have if it had ended about 40 seconds ago. Bobby Clark, plus 47 on the season, led the Flyers in that category this year. And there's the buzzer to end the second period. But a big finish.
Well, that was some between period show for you fans out in Denver, Colorado. And I think maybe it is time that your voices be
brought to the forefront and you do something about it, because this hockey team is putting on quite a show for you. It has all season long, and it's doing a heck of a job here tonight, even being outshot 25-14. And only down your voices be brought to the forefront and you do something about it, because this hockey team is putting on quite a show for you. It has all season long, and it's doing a heck of a job here tonight, even being outshot 25-14. And they're only down 2-1 with 20 minutes of hockey left to go. And I don't know what to do about it. I hate to see a franchise go from anywhere. Joe and I have been through this several times together. This time he's going to go through it alone, but with you fans there in Denver, and I hope you can keep him there, because hockey is a most valuable commodity, and I think somebody ought to do something about it, because I'm getting a little bit upset with all of this talk every place I wind up going.
Okay, well, let's give you some of the other scores. Detroit at the end of two leads Atlanta 4-1 in Atlanta. Toronto shutting out LA at the end of two, 4-0 in Toronto. And Buffalo shutting out the Rangers 2-0 at the end of two in Buffalo. So at the moment, the most competitive game in the four series going on is right here. A very tight checking close game, 20 minutes remaining, only a one goal difference. And the Rockies, of course, giving up that goal with 29 seconds to go to Bobby Clark. Let's see what it does to their performance and the way they play this third period. They're going to have to open up a little bit now. They've been playing it close to the vest, hoping that they would come up with that second goal, but they didn't. The Flyers did. So now the Rockies are under the gun, and they've got to come up with a goal. And again, just referring briefly to Mr. Vickers' statements, nobody wants that team to stay more than he does. Believe me, the gentleman, he's a classy guy. He's poured a fortune already into this franchise. You know and I know, as I said, there is no way it can miss in Denver, but they got to get some help from the city of Denver, and it's about time the city of Denver woke up and smelled the coffee, because they have been very, very slow to react in the past and have had other problems develop in the similar circumstance. All right, face-off at center ice. And the puck in the neutral zone back to Philadelphia. Bob Daly takes it back in his own zone in front of Bernie Parent. Over to the far side. The point gets it to center to Kindrachuk. In the neutral zone, Daly up the right wing, moving on Beck. Blue line, drills it wide. Near boards to Bridgman. Shoots it behind the net. Beck on defense. Barry loses it to the far boards to Kindrachuk. Out to the point to Daly. Daly shot, and it's just deflected wide. Gets caught in the webbing. Out in front, Flyers try to get a shot, but it won't go. Paymon on the right wing with Kitchen in the middle. Wilf to center ice. Poke checked away by Bridgman. Now to the Colorado zone and offside against Philadelphia at the Colorado blue line.
Joe, it seems as if Philadelphia has come out here and decided to get a quick goal on the Rockies. They have really been exploding right from the opening faceoff of this period. Remember, Bob Daly has got 21 goals himself, and he's been pouring on the pressure.
Face-off in the neutral zone, Dennis Duperrey, Mike Kitchen on left wing, Wilf Paymon on the right side. Dennis number 15, Beck and Van Boxmeer on defense, Barry 5 and Van Boxmeer 4. The first game of the Stanley Cup playoffs, second game Thursday night at McNichols. Tickets on sale tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. Third game here, Saturday night if necessary. Van Boxmeer behind the Colorado net. Rockies have twice beaten this team in Denver, but they have never won a game of the Spectrum in 2 years. Barry Beck to center. Trying to lead it up to Paymon. Paymon in the neutral zone to Duperrey. Trying to give it into Wilf. Wilf trying to beat Bridgman at the left circle. Feeds it back out, and it's behind Kitchen and goes back to center ice. Van Boxmeer carrying it back to his own blue line. Across to Barry Beck. Beck winds up on a 90-foot shot. Goes wide. Taken there by Jimmy Watson. Watson over to Selesky. And Selesky breaking out across his own blue line to center ice. Taken by Bridgman. Bridgman shoots it in wide to Favelle, who's just been superb tonight. Mike Kitchen on the left wing as Clark comes on the ice for Philadelphia. Left wing pass to Hudson, who's out now. Tries to shoot, and Clark forced him off the puck. Back to Billy Barber in the neutral zone. Hold it there to Ahern. Ahern fires it in on Perron, and it goes wide to the near board. Dave Hudson into the corner. Taken by Barber. Barber back at the O's goal line with Ahern right on top of him, forcing him off the puck. Hudson looking for it now. Now Oucher and Hudson. Get it out in front to Spruce. Here's Hudson. He scores! On a brilliant play, and Hudson with a quick lifting wrist shot, and the Rockies are back in it.
Tommy Bladen and the other defenseman who's out there. Let's see, we got Bladen and Jimmy Watson both way out of position. He'll let Hudson walk in all by himself. Watch the pass over, and there it goes in the upper corner, and Bladen trails the play. Both Flyer defensemen totally out of it.
Hudson with the goal, Spruce with the assist.
Law at number 24, Freddie Ahern.
And Freddie Ahern with the assist. And we've got a tie game in the third period in Philadelphia.
First of the playoff.
Now the puck into the Colorado zone. Oucher behind the net around to Spruce on the left wing. Andy up the right side to Ahern. Ahern to the Philadelphia line. Trying to beat the defense. Watson staying right with him. Takes him into the boards. Comes loose to Bobby Clark. Clark at the goal line of Philadelphia. And bringing it up the left side. Makes a good turn on Hudson. Brings it out of the zone to center. Right side to Blayton. Blayton shoots it in wide of Favelle. Comes out in front. Oucher is there to cover up. Oucher and left wing side to Spruce. Spruce sends it out of the zone and down to Andre Dufan. Has it at the Philadelphia blue line. Back up the right side to Blayton. Blayton lets it go back in his own zone as Spruce forces him off, and the Rockies are in a line change. And you don't think that goal's going to give him a lift. I'd be very surprised if it doesn't. McLeish to Kelly. Kelly's got Dupont. He shoots. Favelle blocks it. Kelly out in front, just behind McLeish. Shot, and Favelle with a save. Flyers trying to come right back with Favelle again making the big play.
Joe, I don't know if this is going to help Rocky fans take heart, but the Flyers have not been shooting very well. The last three games, a statistic, maybe we'll pick up Rocky fans. In the last three games, the Flyers are only 5 goals for the last 116 shots on net.
Favelle has really been working the feet well tonight, I'll tell you. He's had a lot of tough kick-out saves. Here's the long shot down the middle, and you can see it rising, and Doug watching it all the way makes the catch. Good camera work, by the way. They're doing a great job tonight. Now the shot through the crease. Back out to Dupont at the point. In traffic, and it hit Van Boxmeer. Flyers, McLeish, and Pierce. Now it comes out to Klassen. Klassen brings it to center, right wing to Andrup. Andrup to the Philadelphia line. Backhands it in on goalkeeper Perron. Near boards over to Kelly. Kelly at the goal line. Pierce right behind him. Comes off to McLeish. Oh, look out. Pierce ran hard. So let's hope Randy's all right. He is the most injury-prone player on the Rockies by far. He's had all sorts of problems this year, and let's hope this isn't another one. Looks like he's going to be okay. Just went in hard, but the saga of Randy Pierce this year. First three games with a back injury, then 6 games with a Charlie horse. Here it is again. Watch him go around the net. You can see Kelly puts him into the post, and he goes flying up in the air. Then 4 more games with a shoulder injury, or 8 more games with a shoulder injury, so he's been out a long, long time this year.
Didn't he get hurt here?
That's right. He got hurt in this very building.
He got hurt here in January,
right.
As I remember. They carried him out on a stretcher.
So Randy's had a tough rookie season. He even changed his number from 8 to 7 when Kelly said 8's an unlucky number. Give me that shirt. And tore it up right in the dressing room one night. Made him switch to 7. Then he got hurt after he wore 7.
Oh, no.
So he better switch to another one, I guess. Now Van Boxmeer out of his own zone in a tie game. Pass over to Pearson. It's just behind him. Perron way out of the net, has trouble with it. Net is empty right out in front, and it rolled off Perron almost back in. Now Reggie Leach poke checked away as Andrup races for the puck. Taken by Kevin McCarthy. Rockies are starting to hum. Puck behind the net. Flyers have it at the goal line. They lose it. Here's Pierce. Oh, he just missed as he rattled it wide of the net. Out to Beck at the left point. In behind the net to McCarthy. At the far boards with Ron Andrup. It's tied up and held for a faceoff. And Randy Pierce came within inches of giving the Rockies the lead. And a change of line for both teams. Paymont, Duperrey, and Kitchen. Got to wear a quieter headset there, Michael. I'm going to take your ears off.
It wouldn't be the first time.
Oucher and Mike Christie on defense for the Colorado Rockies. 2-2 tie, 16 minutes remain in regulation. Now the Flyers. Rick Lapointe up the left wing side. Oh, for Bridgman. He's onside. No, he isn't. I was waiting to see if Armstrong was going to blow the whistle when he touched it. He did. So it's an offside pass and the faceoff back down to the Philadelphia end of the ice.
Tell you, Joe, no team like the Rockies has given the Flyers as hard a time all season long. The Rockies essentially knocked the Flyers out of first place and caused this playoff for the Flyers. And, of course, by doing that, they got themselves into the playoffs. So this is quite a matchup, one I think a lot of people outside of Philadelphia and Denver are very surprised to see even occur, much less the score coming down right now.
Duperrey on the faceoff against Doris Kindrichuk in the Philadelphia zone. Paymont wrestling with Bridgman. You can see him with the sticks on each other, trying to get position for that faceoff. Dave Newell going over to talk to both of them. Tell him, come on, guys, take it easy. Back out to Christie down the middle. Mike moves in for the shot. Perron with a save and clears it off to Bob Daly. Daly at the Philadelphia goal line. Out to Kindrichuk at center. Watch for Bridgman on the left wing, but they throw it to the right wing. Puck in behind the net. Kitchen racing forward there. Kitchen in against the boards. Puck rolls loose. Oucher turning around, trying to get it free. Comes off to Daly at the far circle. Fires it behind the net. Man out in front is Kindrichuk. Duperrey trying to stay with him. Daly a shot, and Favelle had the angle. Out to Paymont. Wolf to center, the captain of the team, and he's had a superb year. Trying to break through the defense. Taken out of it by Lapointe. Perron way out of the net, almost to the boards, to grab the puck and hold on.
The move so, you...
15 and a half minutes remaining in the regulation time. The score is tied at two apiece. We'll be right back. 15 minutes remaining in regulation time. The puck goes to Barry Beck at the Colorado goal line. Carries it in behind the net. He's poke checked away. Goes to Van Boxmeer. Johnny has it at the goal line. Trying to avoid Holmgren. Near side to Freddie Ahern. Ahern backing up with Barber. Puck behind the net to Boxy. Left wing side to Andy Spruce, who set up that great goal by Hudson. And it's back into the center ice area to Jimmy Watson. Rockies had 21 ties on the year, only three short of the all-time record by the Flyers, who had 24, but there'll be no tie tonight. Puck goes into the zone. Barber! And Favell with a save puts it up in the air. Everybody almost jumping for it. Barber turning around. Everybody in the crease. Favell has lost his stick. Here's a shot. And Favell, what a catch! My, oh my, what a play by Favell. Without his stick, had nothing but his glove, and made a great play.
I'll tell you, that was Clarkie's problem, because he knew Favell didn't have a stick, and yet he put it on his glove side. I don't know why he did that. There is no explanation for that. Here comes Barber's shot, and that one Favell stops. It was right at him, though. The Flyers just not shooting for the corners. They put a lot right in his midsection. Comes around again, looks for somebody to pass to. He sees Clark. Clark sees Favell does not have a stick, and yet puts it on the glove side.
Good point, Michael. Okay, faceoff in the Colorado zone. 14:40 to play. In regulation time, it's tied at two apiece. Rick McLeish on the faceoff. Doug Favell set in the net. Ron Andrick for the Colorado Rockies. And it comes off on defense to Oucher. Dennis Oucher, who overskated the puck, has to go back for it. Now lost it. Here's Leach, but he couldn't hold it. Reggie anticipating a little bit too quickly. Now the Flyers try to jam it out in front. Favell forces it into the corner. Taken there. Racing forward, Christie can't get it. Now Kelly's slashed at behind the net. Puck still loose. Andrick trying to get it loose. Christie still behind the net. Rockies almost put it out in front. And comes away to Andrew from the left wing. Klassen breaking up the middle. Right wing to Pierce. Pierce winds up, fakes the shot. Goes in around DuPont in a nice move. Gets it, still has it. Now Klassen didn't realize it was on a skate. Reggie Leach puts it around the boards to the near side. Flyers have the puck. Andre DuPont gets it to center. Oucher takes it neutral zone. Trying to fire it back up. Lost it to DuPont. Gets away from Pierce. Brings it in. The Moose breaking on the right wing, and Christie takes him out of the play into the boards. Randy Pierce around to the near side. Room for McLeish. His shot is blocked. Kelly gets it and loses it. Dennis Oucher at the Colorado goal line. Oucher behind his own net with 13 and a half minutes to play. Left wing pass to Mike Christie. Christie brings it up. Up to Andruff at center. Andruff skated off by Lonsberry, and it comes back to Philadelphia's Kevin McCarthy. Right side to Kindrichuk. In behind the net, Kindrichuk at the goal line. He and Christie battle there. Puck against the boards as Andruff comes in on it. Flyers trying to get free for a shot. Here's the point. He shoots. Oh, Favell! What an incredible play by Favell. Again, he comes back and makes an unbelievable save.
Rick LaPointe, Joe, had Favell dead to rights. He gave him the puck, took it away, and tried to put it in, but just that extra move. Doug Favell dove out and knocked it off his stick. LaPointe made one move too many, and it cost him, and it saved the Rockies. Watch LaPointe give it to him, take it away, and try to put it back again, and Favell just stopped him.
What a series of saves that time by Doug Favell. 2-2 tie, 13:09 to play. Doug laying at the side of the net. Now the faceoff to Philadelphia. Out in front to Bridgman. Lost it. The Rockies pick it up. Van Boxmeer to the near side to Paymont. Wilf breaks out the right wing. Puts it in the middle to Kitchen. Kitchen back up the right side to Van Boxmeer. Gets it into Wilf. He's in deep. He goes for the short shot, but it's blocked away by LaPointe. Out in front. Here's Duper. Gets it into Van Boxmeer. He shoots, and a good save by Bernie Perron.
Got a score in the third period. Buffalo 3-1 over the Rangers. Rangers, Steve Vickers with a goal, they show us. And Buffalo, Josh Gavermont has at least one. We've only got one name on there.
Face off to the left-hand side of Perron, who just made a big play. Rockies were close to getting the lead for the first time. 2-2, 12:45 in regulation remaining. And 17,077 making some noise now.
Do you believe the Rockies have been outshot 32-18? And all I have to say in defense of Bernie Perron is the fact that when you're the entire game's being played down at the other end, you have a tendency to get just a little bit cold. And that might have happened to Bernie during this game, because all the heat has been on Favell, and he's withstood it all.
Let's go, Flyers. The cry goes up in the spectrum. Dennis Duperrey on the faceoff. Mike Kitchen out with Wilf Paymont. Beck and Van Boxmeer on defense. Horace Kindrichuk on the draw against Duperrey. It's Bridgman jumping in early, a number one pick of the Flyers in a trade that they worked out with the Capitals a couple of years ago. Jimmy Watson has it behind his net. Around the boards to Selesky. Beck coming in and anticipating the play. Berry gets it at the point but can't hold it, and it goes to center. Duperrey winning the race for the puck. Now Beck pokes it away to center. Bladen winds up for a long shot, rolls wide at Favelle. Doug stops it and leaves it for Van Boxmeer. John up to the left wing side to Kitchen. Kitchen forced back in behind the net to Van Boxmeer. John bringing it out the right side. He pops it up the middle, and it goes all the way down to the Philadelphia zone. Tommy Bladen backing up. Kitchen right in front of him. Paymont looking for a steal. Can't get it. It comes to Oucher. Oucher in the neutral zone. Back to Clark. Bobby Clark up the middle to the Colorado line. Right wing pass. Selesky, a shot. A rebound. Oh, and Clark just missed. Back to Jimmy Watson. Shoots it behind the net to Clark. Clark taken into the board. Still has possession of the puck. Being grabbed and pushed down. No whistle. They battle hard against the boards now, and look out for something breaking out here.
Well, whenever Bobby Clark gets manhandled, you know most of the Flyers will come to his rescue. It's not the way it was when Dave Schultz was here, and there's been a lot of talk about that. But they still seem to try to protect their captain, Bobby Clark.
Okay, 11:54 to play in the game. The score tied at 2. We'll be right back. Years ago, the line now out for the Flyers combined for 141 goals, a National Hockey League record. Bobby Clark at center, Reggie Leach on the right wing, Bill Barber on the left side. So Freddie Giroux reuniting the big guns to see if he can get a goal. Faceoff comes out to the point. Back to DuPont. DuPont shoots it across to the far side and knocked away by Lefley. And look out here. Oucher and Clark. Oucher and Clark, as one of the Flyers, of course, races in immediately to protect Clark, as is the case.
Oucher tried to take Clark out in front of the net as that puck flew off the ice surface and into the crowd. And as soon as he did that, Kevin McCarthy skated all the way from the right point to take on Oucher.
Good close-up of Bobby Clark there. You can see that cameraman right down at the edge of the action, huh? So, things heating up, and tempers have got to start getting a little short, and the tension is building. We have less than 12 minutes to play in regulation time. The first game of a three-game playoff series between the Rockies and the Philadelphia Flyers. NHL action at its best. Stanley Cup playoffs. If you've been to McNichols this year, you just know how much fun this game can be. The Rockies have been so entertaining. The standing room only crowds in recent weeks. The excitement, the enthusiasm. And let's get it all back together next year, huh? 2-2 tie. Come on out Thursday night and pack that place. Dave Hudson, Bobby Clark, outer rim of the circle, Colorado zone. Ahern on the right wing, number 24 in your picture. And number one in your hearts. Back out to the point to Bob Daly. Across to LaPointe. He's got room. He shoots and lifts it upstairs into the seats. And some great games played in this stadium. I'll never forget the Russian game here in January of 76. Against the Russian Army. Clark against Karlamov. Back in 72, Bobby Clark in Team Canada decided Karlamov was doing too much harm. So he took Karlamov out. He slashed him across the ankles and broke it. Pick Eric Karlamov for the series, fortunately or unfortunately, I guess. Hudson against Clark, and it comes out across the center ice to Rick LaPointe. LaPointe backhands it in. Beck will chase it down behind the net. Nelson Piatt sitting this game out. Souzer has not played tonight. Out to center ice to Spruce, right wing to Ahern. Ahern trying to break through the defense, but Daly grabs the loose puck. Back to center. Spruce trying to force him backwards again. Now Clark shoots it in. Knocked down by Beck, comes across the center, and they'll call the high stick because Ahern touched it was the key. If it had gone to a Flyer, it would in effect been a no harm, no foul situation, and they would have allowed the play to continue. 11:21 to go in the game, the faceoff and the Colorado under the ice.
Bernie Parent's asking for a little bit of timeout. He wants a different goal stick. That's about third time he's changed tonight, Joe.
Looking for the lucky one, I guess.
We don't have the camera on it, but in fact, what are we going to see here? This is where he... Oh! He's going to hit a triple with that one.
That's right.
Jimmy Watson's carrying Bernie a stick down at the other end while the replay's on there.
And here comes Dornhofer back out for only the second time tonight, and his first appearance lasted about 5 seconds.
It's about third time out tonight. He has not gotten a lot of ice time, but they want a guy to mix it up in front. Gary Dornhofer is all elbows.
Now the faceoff, and Andriff grabs it at the blue line and brings it out to center. Ronnie across the red line, shoots it in behind Bernie Parent. Knocks it down there. Perron finished second in the Vezina race this year behind Kenny Dryden and Bunny Larocque. Gary Dornhofer, his own zone, out to center, right wing to McLeish, backhands it into the Colorado under the ice. Lavelle is letting it go because we should get an icing and will. As Van Boxmeer touches the puck, they'll bring it back down to the other end. 11 minutes exactly remain in regulation as John Van Boxmeer, close up in your picture.
I think people who tuned into hockey pretty well assumed this series would be close, and I think everybody else who has not been into hockey would have said, well, the Flyers are just going to cream them, you know, who are the Rockies? But I think if they've been watching the Flyers and Rockies the last couple of months, they knew this would be a hard-fought series, and that's exactly what we've got going here.
Well, I'll tell you, this team has come so far on just sheer hard work and persistence. You figure all the injuries, 18 guys out at various times, at one time seven players out of the lineup, seven regulars at one time.
It's a whole team.
And yet here is the team in the Stanley Cup playoffs and battling the Flyers in the third period in the Spectrum at a tie game. Lonsberry in his own zone, backing up to the goal line. Pierce trying to stay right with him. Klassen coming in on the play. Pierce with a steal, trying to put it out in front. Randy gets it out to the point, and Van Boxmeer had it jump through him and quickly puts it back in. They may call the intentional offside, and they will. Have the faceoff down at the Colorado end of the ice. That's Neil Armstrong, veteran linesman, said he's worked more games than any official in the history of the National Hockey League.
Well, Atlanta's coming back on Detroit, still in the third. Mr. Redmond, Dickey Redmond with a goal, making 4-3 Detroit over Atlanta.
It's like a dramatic finish.
That's in the third period. That is not a final yet.
That was 4-0 at one point.
We don't know how much time's left in the third period, but
can't
gotta be a couple
much.
Of minutes.
Yeah. Faceoff to the right-hand side of Doug Favell, Dennis Duperrey. Will Paymont. Norris Kinderchuk, the faceoff man for the Flyers. Flyers lost only six games in this building all season long. Van Boxmeer at the goal line to the left wing, but it's held in at the point. Flyers feed out in front off of Favell's shoulder, picked up by Wilf and does not clear it. Held in, a shot, oh, just over the top of the net. Comes back out in front to Bridgman. His shot is blocked. Barry Beck gets it at the near boards. Now Beck shoots it around to Kitchen on the left wing. Mike trying to flip it out, but it didn't go, and the Flyers hold it in again. Tangle along the boards, and again, the elbows go up high. We'll have a faceoff.
Okay, Kevin McCarthy playing a very aggressive point position, came way in from the blue line to tie that up. That's a dangerous play this late in the hockey game, but he came in and he tied Kitchen up with the puck.
2-2 tie, 10-18 remaining in regulation time. We'll be back in just a moment. We're back at the Spectrum with 10-15 remaining in regulation time to tie game. John Van Boxmeer for the Colorado Rockies at his own goal line. Breaking out. Carries it to center ice. Duperrey in front of him. Now he breaks to the right wing. Winds up in a high, hard one off the glass and to the far boards. Kitchen holds it in. He's taken it to the boards. Holmgren grabs it there. Paymont comes right in on him. They hit it against the boards and it's held for a faceoff.
Paymont and McCarthy.
Look out. Here we go again. This is Kitchen this time.
That's right.
And Mike, this is not a time, though. I think both teams now are in a position, Mike, where they might think about wanting to start something, but they better not. They can't afford it right now. A fight would be a disaster. Here's Bridgman trying to sucker Paymont.
That's right. When they want to fight, what they want to do is take out your best player, and you're going to see a couple of the Rockies going at Clarkie, and you're going to see a couple of the Flyers going at after Duperrey and Paymont. You know, if you're going to have a fight, have one of your lesser players take out
right.
one of their scorers.
And don't think that was exactly what Bridgman was trying to do. Paymont, not one time in 100 would he take a move that Bridgman just made on him right now when he shoved him up against the glass. But Wilf, the captain of the team, under 10 minutes to go, you just cannot afford to have him come out of the lineup. But right now, McCarthy and Kitchen are both going off.
Well, we've also got a score in. Toronto is absolutely creaming the Kings, 6-0, and that's in the third period as well. Mr. Ferguson, two goals there for Toronto.
Kevin McCarthy, each 2 minutes for roughing.
2 minutes for roughing, that's a good call.
6 seconds.
So look out here, though, because many, many times a goal is scored when the teams are at five aside. You've got that extra ice room out there, and a close-checking game like this, that little extra bit of room out there, a little more ice room, you never know what can happen. And so Dave Hudson's going to go out there for the face-off. He's out with Freddie Ahern, Oucher, Mike Christie. Close up of Mike Kitchen, third round pick of the Rockies last year. They didn't have a first round pick. Gardner was their, or they didn't have a second round pick. Gardner was their first round pick, and then Mike was picked on the third round. So a face off to the right hand side of Bernie Perron. 9:54 to go. If there's a next goal at this stage of the game, that could be it. Kinderchuk and Hudson, and it comes off to Philadelphia's Daly. Daly brings it up the middle. looking for Leach on the left side. Puck comes off in front of Pavel. He has to dive way out of the net to grab it. Rick Lapointe gets free at the point. Moving in close. Shoots it across to Daly. Daly back to Lapointe on the left side. In deep at the left circle. Puts it out in front. It rolls in, and Leach tried to almost kick it in off his skate underneath, but apparently Pavel is on top of it in the right place. It started rolling under, Doug, and I thought for a second maybe it was going to go all the way under.
Rick Lapointe making a couple of rookie mistakes. He is a rookie. I say mistakes if you're a Flyer fan, and obviously something you want to see if you're a Rocky fan. Since we're talking to your Rockies, I've got to say that he made a couple of good moves for you. Just overpassing, not watching his passing, and not taking a shot when he had it. That's something some rookies do, and that's the kind of thing that gets eliminated the longer you're in the NHL, or you don't stay in the NHL very long.
So the penalties have 1:42 to go. Regulation time has 9:36 to go. Ahern and Hudson, but now Klassen is coming out, so he'll replace one of them, probably Freddie.
And Rockies had better watch out. Ricky McLeish is on the ice now, and you've got all that kind of ice room out there with two men off. Rick can wheel and deal, and he's got a wrist shot that's about the best around.
And Klassen apparently just went out for a skate because he didn't stay in. He just skated around and got right back off. Face off, right-hand side of Pavel, McLeish. And the draw comes off to Rick, and he puts it right through the crease. McLeish with a good opportunity. Out to the point to Daly. Daly drills it, and the Rockies get it across the center ice as bounces it off of Hudson. Now Lapointe bringing it back in. He's poke-checked away, and it goes back to center. Daly at the red line. Across on the left wing, gets it to McLeish. Shoots it back in. Lonsberry deep at the circle. He shoots. Rebound comes Auger. And the net comes completely off, and Daly goes sliding through it.
He hit that net. He hit the crossbar with his hip, and he went flat down. He's obviously okay, but for a moment there, you didn't know what was going to happen. Watch him come into this net. He just lifts it right up off the pegs.
There it is as he goes sliding in, and boom. Oh, boy. That's quite a collision. 9-11 remaining in the game. Change of lines and a face-off to the left-hand side of Doug Pavel. This close-up of Big Bob Daly. Perry out for the Rockies. Thursday night, McNichols Arena. And remember, people on the phones right now at the Rockies office, 534-PUCK for ticket information for next year's season tickets. And that's the best kind of support you can show right now, by the way, for the Colorado Rockies. 534-PUCK.
Final score, Buffalo beat the Rangers 4-1.
Now the puck down the ice into the Philadelphia zone. And it gets to the goal line. Looks like they will call the icing. So Buffalo has won their first game. Gary McAdam got the last goal for Buffalo. And so the Rangers now have to go back to Madison Square Garden down by one game.
Why don't we show this to Floyd Smith, who's sitting over there. Floyd?
He heard it. And Toronto, as you say, Mike, look at that. 6-0. Ferguson getting two goals, apparently. And the crowd firing up again. They want to get the key goal here. And you get to this stage of the game, any goal, boy, is it a big one now. 9 minutes remaining. Faceoff, left-hand side of Pavel. Duperre against Kindrychuk. Jimmy Watson is out there. Rockies have Barry Beck, Van Boxmeer, and Wolf Paymon. Faceoff comes off to Beck. Trying to get it to the Duper. Out to Bladen. Now into the boards. Duperre turning around for the loose puck. Grabs it. Hooked it and puts it down the ice. And this one I don't think is going to reach the goal line. It won't. Stops and taken by Jimmy Watson. Paymon trying to track him and catch him, but he can't. Watson turns around, brings it to center. Across the Colorado line to the right wing. Has Bridgman down the middle, drops a pass, and Paymon brings it back. He's got a man to beat. Blade goes down the right wing, trying to go around him. Shoots! Oh, he just missed wide. Van Boxmeer at the left circle. Puts it back in behind the net to Wilf. Wilf looking for a man out in front. Gives it to Boxy, and it jumps over his stick as the Flyers block it away. Puck stays in the zone, now out to center. Penalties have 25 seconds to go. Carthy and Kitchen. Now to Beck. Beck at the blue line. Brings it in. Drills it. And look out. Upstairs into the seats. 8:14 to play in the game. Or in regulation, we should say.
Well, if this thing goes in overtime, you're going to foul up my 11 o'clock show here in Philadelphia because I have got to go live at 11. And if this game's going on, I don't think I can get my camera off the action on the ice. So we're going to have a little bit of a situation here getting our local news on tonight.
Bobby Clark averaging 88 points per season in his NHL career. Finished this year with 89. Ron Andruff on the faceoff against Clark. Klassen out there. Beck, or Christie, I should say, and Auger. 8:14 remaining in regulation time. Off to Andre Dupont, the Philadelphia goal line. has it there, shoots it to the far side. Now Daly to center to Clark. Clark and Barber up front. Pass into DuPont. He's got a step on Oucher. Goes for the backhander. Favelle with a save, the rebound. And blocked away to Klassen. He wants to get it out of the zone. And the Flyers hold it in, but it comes back to Klassen. Klassen brings it up the middle. The penalties are over. Right side to Andra. He skated off the puck by DuPont. Oucher shoots it in. Wide of goalkeeper Bernie Perron. Over to Bob Daly. Daly at the goal line. Around to the near side to Billy Barber. Barber and Ahern. Now behind the net to Klassen. Klassen, but DuPont gets it. Over to the far side to Reggie Leach. Leach to center. To Clark. Barber on the left side. Into the zone. Leach going in front of the net. He's looking for the rebound. A pass, a tip by Barber just missed. Diving for the puck. Now the Rockies put it out to center. 7:20 in regulation. Daly from the blue line. Back to Leach. He shoots. It's wide. Back around the boards. Held in by Watson. Right out in front. They try to jam it in. Oucher picks it up and gets it to Ahern, who intentionally sends it down the ice. Bernie Perron grabs the loose puck. Ahern moving on Jimmy Watson. Carries it in. Looking for an open man. He gets Hudson. Hudson shoots. It's blocked in front. And Perron clears it away and dives on the puck in front of Andy Spruce. Perry against Kindrachuk. Face off in the Philadelphia zone. Beck and Van Boxmeer at the blue line. This crowd getting very nervous here. Sellout, but a little bit worried because anything can happen at this stage. That next goal. Here's a pass to Duperrey. Puts it to the near boards in the Philadelphia end. Grabbed by DuPont. DuPont shoots it out to the point. Van Boxmeer shoots. Grabbed by Perron and leaves it behind the net. Now it rolls to the far boards. Kitchen racing Kindrachuk. Mike trying to put it out in front. Rockies battling for it. Duperrey and Paymon wait out in front. It comes out to the point. Beck can't get it, and it goes to center. Van Boxmeer backing up at the Colorado blue line. Shoots it across right wing to Wilt. Passed him. Knocked down to the neutral zone. Back into the Colorado end of the ice. Picked up by Van Boxmeer. Sends it back to the near boards. Flyers grab possession, though. Kindrachuk. Kindrachuk at the goal line. Battling for it there. Rockies staying with him and tie it up for a faceoff. 5:43 remaining regulation time. Faceoff right out to Jimmy Watson. Watson with a backhander off a leg, and it comes off to Paymon. Paymon up the left wing, brings it to center, looking for Kitchen, but it's forced back in by the Flyers. Barry Beck racing for the puck, gets it to Will. He puts it out just past Kitchen at center ice and rolls to the Philadelphia end, where we'll have an icing call here. 2-2. Faceoff. Duper gets it to Oucher. Oucher in his own zone. And the faceoff comes to Van Boxmeer. John trying to flip it out, but the Flyers, ooh, almost had a good setup in front of the net. Here's Jimmy Watson. Watson, he shoots the backhander, and it's just chipped away. Now to Ahern on the right wing. Freddie can't get it out as the Flyers continue to push. Van Boxmeer at the near boards, and it comes out down the middle. Here's Bladen. He tries to shoot. Favelle dives for the puck. It comes loose. Goes to the corner. Andy Spruce poking it out to the point, but it doesn't leave. Clark and Hudson tie it up. Back to Barber. Barber down the middle. Gets it over to Watson. Watson in front, and Favelle at the side of the net clears it away to Freddie Ahern. Ahern wants a faceoff, and again it's tied up with just over 4 minutes remaining in regulation time. Man. 4 minutes to go. Any goal at this stage of the game could be the winner. Ron Andruff out against Rick McLeish, right-hand side of Favelle. Sellout crowd of the Spectrum. Face-off stays right in the circle. And Boxmeer gets it, shoots it to center. And the Flyers will chase it down to their own end of the ice. And Tommy Bladen picks it up just short of the goal line. Bladen in front of his own net. Trying to bring it back up the middle. Shoots it to center. Pass on the left wing to McLeish. McLeish from the blue line drills it wide. Goes to the far boards. Picked up by Beck. Beck out to Klassen. Klassen gets it to center. Here's Pearson, a race with DuPont. DuPont slashes it back. Klassen loses the puck. Flyers pick it up. They bring it in. Breaking in at the right circle is Holmgren. Shoots it behind the net. Racing forward, Van Boxmeer. Around the boards. Back out to DuPont at the point. Shoots it to the far corner. Barry Beck racing Holmgren there. Now back in behind the net. Van Boxmeer against the boards and another faceoff. 2-2 tie. The goals of the game, the Colorado Rockies, Stu Perry and Dave Hudson. And for Philadelphia, it's McLeish getting the first goal of the night and the second goal by Bobby Clark. Puck down to the Colorado zone. In behind the net, a feed out in front. Blocked away, and the Rockies, again, just shoot it down. Again, this time we will have an icing, I believe. And it touches and touched by Philadelphia. And here's a final score. Detroit beat Atlanta 5-3.
matter which way it goes, it's got to set them up Thursday night pretty good to know they at least went this far, even if
they
happen to lose the game.
That's right. Regardless of what happens, I believe that this team is showing, again, incredible character and determination. Now the puck out to center ice. The Flyers backing up for it. Back it goes to Daly. Daly being pressed by Mike Kitchen. Paymont trying to steal, couldn't get it. Comes to Bridgman. Bridgman shoots it in, knocked down by Beck. Clears it over to Duperre. Can't get it out. Flyers hold it in, but now Beck picks it up and flips it out to center. Back it goes to Rick Lapointe at the Philadelphia blue line with under 3 minutes to go in regulation time. Across to Daly. Daly shoots it into the Colorado end of the ice and behind the net. Barry Beck racing forward there. Beck at the near boards, can't get it out, but it comes to Oucher. Oucher forces it, but it doesn't leave. Here's Bridgman down the middle, getting in close. Backhander, and Pavel gets a stick on it. Near boards, Paymont trying to force it out. In against the boards and shot down the ice.
By the way, right now, the Flyers are really playing cautious. They're only sending one man deep, and they're keeping everybody back by the Rocky blue line in this season.
Important draw in the Colorado zone with Leach and Barber lining up for shots. Armstrong dropping the puck, and it comes off to Colorado, and they get it out to center. Back to Jimmy Watson. Rockies have not had much puck possession, though, in the last 8 or 10 minutes of the game. Now Hudson. Hudson at center. Shoots it, tries to shoot it back in, but it rolls to Bobby Clark. Clark in his own zone up the right wing. Christie breaks it up there. Back to Andy Spruce. Spruce in the Colorado end of the ice, trying to force it out. Rockies can't clear it. Trying to kick it out across the line. It doesn't leave. Back in behind the net. Pavel leaves it there. Over to Oucher. Oucher brings it up, fires it to center, and too far, but right in on Pirano, has to make a stop, so no icing. And we have less than 2 minutes to go in regulation time. Jimmy Watson for the Flyers. Puts it up the right wing. Here's Leach racing Christie. Christie wins the race and forces it back to center. Clark has to wait for Leach to get onside. And they tie up along the boards in the neutral zone with 1:37 to go.
Who would have thought it? Who would have thought this game going right down to the wire would be tied at 2? The Rockies have got to be tremendously congratulated. Doug Pavel in particular, he has been outshot 40-18. Do you believe those numbers? 40-18, and Pavel has stopped all but 2 of those 40.
So a neutral zone faceoff coming up. Dave Hudson out for the Rockies. Andy Spruce on the left, Ahern on the right. Beck and Van Boxmeer on defense. It's interesting that Beck tonight has had very few shots on the net. A typical Rocky game, he will be powdering him continuously, but he's playing a cautious, defensive, solid game tonight and not thinking offense. They're on the road, you have to be careful. But you got to win, too. There's no tie tonight. Gaining a point doesn't do much for you in the playoffs, folks. You've got to win it. Now Van Boxmeer crosses his own blue line, brings it up the right wing, hits Hudson. Hudson into the zone, in deep at the circle, carries it all the way in, has men out in front, hits to the point to Beck, hits it on the move, he shoots it wide. Back out in front it comes, a shot, and a deflection just missed. Spruce trying to put it out in front. Puck rolls to Clark, hit by Ahern. Clark gets free with 1:12 to go. Shoots it across ice, a good flurry by the Rockies. Now Daly up the right wing, puts it in wide of Pavel. To the near boards to Clark. Now Van Boxmeer and Clark. Back to the near side. The Rockies trying to clear it. Ahern gets it. Banks it out to center. Taken by Rick Lapointe. Lapointe back to Clark. Clark at the right circle. Brings it in deep. Headmans it in. Rolls through Pavel. Back to the near boards. Back out to the point to Rick Lapointe. He shoots it wide. Back out in front. And Pavel gloves it as it comes back in his hands with 44 seconds remaining. So faceoff to the right-hand side of Doug. 2-2 tie, 44 seconds to go.
And nobody wants to play giveaway right now. Everybody wants to play cautious, which is kind of silly because they've got 44 seconds to win it. Everybody's afraid of the 44 seconds they've got
right.
to lose
so
it.
Somewhere you got to win it.
That's right. And eventually, here's that shot by Rick Lapointe again. But somewhere down the line, when we get it to overtime, if we do, somebody's going to have to turn it on to win it. You can't play cautious the entire night. And it's strange to see the Flyers in this position, and I've got to say that as someone who's watched them play the last 3 months consistently.
Now the puck stays in the Colorado end of the ice, in behind the net. Kindrychuk trying to get free, has it at the goal line, puts it out to the point. Here's Bladen, he shoots! Oh, Pavel! The puck is loose, it's still in front of the net, and we had a whistle. It's underneath Pavel, and no goal.
It certainly is, and our fans can see right there, it is just short of the crease by about 3 inches. Pavel sat on it. Thank you, Fonzie.
Oh, my. 30 seconds? Wouldn't that have been something? What a finish.
Oh.
We have a commercial break we need with 30 seconds to go in the game. I think we ought to stay right here, and we'll run it afterwards, okay? See what happens.
And that's how Joe keeps his job. Smart call, Joe.
Okay, face off to the right-hand side of Doug Favell. Dennis Duperrey out against Doris Kindrichuk. The Flyers have Jimmy Watson on the left and Bladen on the right as they try to go for a winner in the last 30 seconds of face-off in the Colorado zone. Comes Doucher. Doucher at the near boards, takes it into the boards again, and it's piled up with 25 seconds remaining. This thing goes into overtime. You might hear from everybody in the press box before we get through tonight. I'm going to be talking to so many people trying to fill up those intermissions, because if it gets to the last 30 seconds, you have a full 15-minute break.
And during that break, I'm going to be busy myself, so enjoy your talk with everybody else. I'm going to be talking myself.
Now Oucher up the right side. Can't get it out. Stays in the zone. Oucher behind the net. Around the boards to Kitchen. Kitchen trying to force it out. Out to Bladen. Bladen shoots. Favell with a save. It's blocked to the corner. 12 seconds to go in regulation. Rockies get it to the point. It doesn't leave again. This time it's lifted up into the seats with 6 seconds to go. Michael, I'm going to ask you right out, because I can't break away. See if you can get Jacques Plante and Nellie Pyatt to stand by, will you, please?
I certainly shall. As soon as I do my shot on my station, I will run down and line them up for you.
Mike Capel.
And we're going to get everybody straight. And Jacques Plante, if the fans don't know it, has been helping Bernie Perotti as the Flyers' goaltender coach. And occasionally, between periods, he goes down and gives Bernie some pointers on what he would like to see him do and not do. And, of course, one of the greats, Jacques Plante.
All right, the face-off will be, as you can see, almost at the blue line. And the Rockies, with 6 seconds to go, have to think mostly about...